All right, so we are finally here. Melvin and Charlie on BBC Radio 1.
We made it.
Yeah, man. Welcome to the show. Let's do this. What have they done?
Do you know what? I feel sorry for them now. Sorry, guys.
But you know what? First of all, let's just shout everyone that's been showing us love, our friends, our family, people online, people here at Radio 1.
Yes.
There's been so much love and support, so big up you guys. Now, I've got to say, it's so great to be back on air because that break was, it was good for the first few weeks.
Yes, we haven't been on the radio since December.
I'll be honest, it's been quite nice not having to talk to you two every day.
Don't say that, Charles. You don't mean that. But I didn't know what to do with myself. Actually, I did know what to do with myself.
Well, I've got a feeling that we know what you've been doing. So just to let you guys into a bit of a secret. So just before we came on air, one of our producers went into Melvin's bag looking for post-it notes.
Should we tell him what we found?
So shut your mouth.
What did we find, Joe?
We found lots of protection.
Lots of condoms. I mean, what is wrong with this guy? He's come to work with a bag full of condoms. Why? Who are you?
Well, to be fair, we have got a big team now. We have got a big team.
Okay, can I just say, this wasn't planned. We weren't supposed to talk about what was in my bag. You're both idiots. Let's start the show, all right? So everyone's been talking about what we're going to play for our first song. So I think we should each have a first song.
Yeah,
all right?
Let's do it.
I'm going to kick things off. I want something that's going to reflect our new show. So it's something fresh, exciting, high energy, and a little bit naughty. It has to be Octavian Bett featuring Skepta and Michael Phantom on Radio 1. This is our first tune.
Okay, best.
Well, this feels exciting. Octavian Bett on BBC Radio 1 with Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, 1.
Oh my gosh. All right, so first day. It feels like being the first kid at school, right? The first day at school, basically.
But you know when, like, your first day back and everybody looks really different? I feel like we all look the same. It's like really boring.
It's because it wasn't our first day at school. You guys are adults. You just had some time off,
speak
basically.
For yourself.
But everyone's been so nice to us. It's been such a nice journey.
Yeah.
But we are finally here on BBC Radio 1. We're absolutely loving life. Got some new music for you guys right now. It came out a couple of months ago, actually. Not brand new music. But I wanted to play something for my first track that was going to represent all the elements of music that I absolutely love. So you've got R&B vocals in there, you know, but R&B. You know, I love my dance music, bit of drum and bass as well, and an MC on the beat as well. No better, nothing better than playing this one right now. This is Shy FX, Bad Boy Business, on BBC Radio 1 from his album. It dropped really, really like recently, Ragamuffin Sound Tape. It's massive. Check it out. Nine. BBC Radio 1, Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, we are on your radio till 11. In the background, that is Bad Boy Business, Shy FX from his album Ragamuffin Sound Tape. This song makes me feel so happy. I love it so much.
Big shoes there, Ricks. Shout out to everyone on text on 81199. We've got a few texts in front of me. Shout out to Spark Girl, who says, so glad to hear your voices again. Shout out to Lee Evans, who says, good luck with your first show, guys. Nice one, Lee.
Thank
you. Shout out to Lewis Kelly, who says, let's get hashtag bag full of condoms trending. No, Lewis.
Yes, Lewis.
Well, if you're going to do it, hashtag Melv's bag full of condoms.
Do you know what? In fairness, though, considering like we know what Melv's like, and we've gone through his bag many times before, that was quite tame.
Well, normally he's got 100 in there.
Remember that time we found a whole bottle of wine in his bag?
And some Quality Street.
And Ricky, this is my chance to have a clean slate. And you guys are already ruining things. And also, my mum's listening right now.
Sorry, Auntie.
I'll tell you how to get a clean slate.
Go on.
Don't talk. Just don't say a word, mate. All right, so my first track, I'm so excited. Now, I've been thinking hard about the first track to play for you guys.
Yeah.
And I've come up with this one, all right? So, for many reasons. Number one, I'm a massive house music head.
Yes.
Yep.
Number two, these two guys I'm about to play are creating some massive waves in the house scene at the minute. I was playing out in Miami last week, and honestly, their names were coming up everywhere I went and played. They're making some really interesting sounds that cross over commercially as well. And the pace of it, I think, just explains our show. So, are you ready for this, boys?
Yes, Charles.
This is Camel Fat Breathe on BBC Radio 1.
Yes, Charlie, big tune. That's Camel Fat Breathe. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, 1.
All right, so I want to talk about something.
Uh-oh. Okay.
So I was on Twitter the other day,
yeah,
and I saw a hashtag and it had me in absolute stitches. Now, I want to bring it to the show tonight. So basically, the hashtag was things you can say at the dinner table as well as in our bedroom.
And if you're not Jamaican, that means
in the bedroom.
Okay.
So, have you guys got any examples for me?
Yes.
Of course you do.
Look in my bag, it should be him.
Melba was like, finally. What was up his
sleeve? I can breathe.
I'm going to go for, can I have some more, please?
Please, sir. Please, some more. Oh. Joel?
See, my dad's listening to this. And all right, Dad. Anyway, what one, how many do you want? One or two?
As many as
I'm going to go for
job.
Two. You can never have enough sausage. And number two, I can't talk to you. I've got my mouth full.
All right, so you guys get the picture. We want to hear from you guys about things you can say at the dinner table as well as in the bedroom. Get in contact. Call us on 03 700 100 100. Right now, let's have some Post Malone on BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio.
One.
This week, we're putting our new recruits to the ultimate test.
Ricky,
Melvin,
and Charlie
versus the highest ever scorer on yesterday's quiz.
It's Georgia.
I'm keen to take down Ricky, Melvin, and Charlie.
Listen tomorrow morning from 7:15. Radio 1 Breakfast
with Greg James.
Fling a rag, a rhythm like it's all free. Bossy, house on the post sheet. My money so long it doesn't
know. Sounds of Wiley, Steph London and Sean Paul and Idris Elba on that one. That one's called Bossy. All right, so we're asking you guys this evening things you can say at the dinner table. And in the bedroom. Shout out to everyone getting involved on the text, the 81199. Shout out to Abby in Sunderland who says, my arse is going to burn later.
Oh my word.
That's already my favourite.
Shout out to Antonia, says, wow, that's saltier than I expected.
Oh, rank. That's disgusting.
Shout out to Trevin Scunny. I hope you don't mind, but my roommate is going to be joining us tonight.
I like that one, actually. That's clever.
And big up to Adam, who says, wow, that's greasier than I thought.
Oh, that's rank.
Keep them coming in. 81199.
Nice. Right now, this is 21 Savage featuring J. Cole, A Lot on Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
Big tunes, 21 Savage, J. Cole, BBC Radio 1. So, Rickster,
yo,
what are we asking everyone?
We are asking people things you can say at the dinner table as well as in the bedroom.
There's so many. 81199, keep them coming
I
in.
I think we've set the system into overload.
But they're getting worse and I love it. Stephen in Devon says, that breast tastes amazing. Gem from Norwich, bottoms up. Shout out to Ollie. That's almost as good as your mum's. Don't like that one.
Hello.
Keep on coming in.
The pipe down, Melvin. He was awake all of a sudden, isn't he?
Hello, Melv. You all right?
I've got some here from Jamie. Jamie says, stop playing with it. No, stop playing with it and put it in your mouth.
You stop playing with it and read the text properly. What's wrong with you?
I was like, are we allowed to read this? And I realised it's the evening time.
Yeah. Pass the water,
do
bro.
What we want. Yeah. 409 says, nice buns. Keep them coming in. Online, on text, 81199. It's Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
Sounding so good on Radio 1, that's Cardi B, I like it. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
Absolutely. All right, so we're asking you guys things that you can say at the dinner table and in the bedroom. It's going absolutely mad on the texts. Charlie's been in stitches over there. Melvin's been probably taking notes. We've got Dave on the line. Dave, where are you from?
Chelmsford, Essex.
Dave, Essex!
Essex!
Go on.
All right, so Dave, tell us. What is your example of things that you can say at the dinner table as well as in the bedroom?
My two favourite things, I'll just give you one actually, that tastes really nice.
But I feel like you've held back on the second one. I actually want to hear the second one. What's the other one?
I don't think you're saying if I'm right, but I should say so, no.
All really, right.
Just that tastes is my favourite one.
All right, fair enough.
To be fair, I like it.
We're not going
to
push it. Thanks for your call.
See you later.
Nikki, you there?
Hiya.
Hey, Nikki, where are you calling from?
Calling from
Middle grade.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. All right, so Nick, tell us, what is your example of something that you can say at the dinner table and in the bedroom?
Shout out to the dog as well in the background.
Yeah, shout out, it tastes better than it looks.
I love that one.
Hear, hear.
Do you know what? I've got some...
My mum said one too.
Go on.
Go on.
She said, I don't care if you don't like what it tastes like. Follow.
Pick up your mum.
Your mum. In fact, I won't
you must have enough brothers and sisters, Brett. My days, your mum is saucy.
Oh, I love it. I've got some shouts. Do you want some shouts?
Yeah, go on, Charles. Thanks, Nick.
See you later, Nick.
Thank you.
Hello, Jamie, you there?
Yeah, yep.
Where are you calling from, bro?
I'm calling from Cambridge.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. All right, so give us your example of things you can say at the dinner table as well as in the bedroom.
My example is that was vile. Can I pay half price?
That's the best one.
Man said it straight.
That's the best one.
And then he's busting up.
Cracking up.
Oh, you smashed it.
Jamie, nice one, bro. Thanks for calling, man. One.
BBC Radio.
One. When I make MG, you always complain like Shanaz and me often. But often I'll be OT.
Options on BBC Radio 1, NSG, T on Wayne, Ricky Melvin and Charlie, we're here till 11. Shout out to Josh in Cornwall, says, slow down, or you'll choke on that.
Melvin, Charlie, don't you want to explain why?
That was things that you could say at the dinner table as well as in the bed.
Okay, any more that come through, don't explain. Just do the shouts. I feel like that has more impact. Do you know what I mean?
I don't know if it's that kind of show though, Charles.
Well, listen, for example, if you just heard this, it's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1. I asked for it medium.
Or it's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1. That's creamy.
Exactly, just leave it at that. Leave
Fair
it
enough.
At that.
Let's just live our life like this. First day.
We're past the watershed, man.
Okay, do what you want.
Live your life.
All right, well, it's time for our tune of the week. It's from the 80-year-old Jamaican singer and rapper Coffee. She gave us the banger Toast, which now has over 22 million views on YouTube. Now her next song, Rapture, is from her debut EP of the same name. Check it out right now here on Radio 1. This tune is number 7 in the UK charts. That's Still Bangles, AJ Tracy, Most Stacked Fashion Week. It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie on BBC Radio 1.
So Melvin's decided, I mean, our studio is absolutely massive right now, and Melvin's decided he wants to sit so close to me that every time the mics go up, he keeps turning my headphones down so I can't hear a word.
Charles,
stop touching me.
I'd like to be close to you.
I know, but can you not be that close?
Sorry.
All right, so most importantly, I thought I'd tell you guys that I've had to change my hair wash day.
Why?
Well, because of starting this show. So I used to wash my hair on a Thursday, and now I have to wash it on a Monday.
Let's just end the show.
First world problem.
Can I just say,
Charlie?
Melvin's jealous because he don't have any hair. When's the last time you wash your hair, my friend?
Low blow. Shots fired.
I'm not having it, Rick. I'm not having it. Anyway, so I went to the hair salon this morning. Shout out to Natalie, who does my hair. You always get talking about random stuff, don't you, in a hair salon? Rick's, not Melv. Beard salon. Anyway, so she was saying to me, have you ever got stuck in a top in the changing room if you've gone to try some clothes on? And I was like, what do you mean stuck? Because obviously we've all been in a position before where you've put a top on and you're like, you get it over, you know, one boob and then you try and get over the right and then you're completely stuck. But I've never been stuck.
Oh, I know. Okay.
Okay, so... First question, in male changing rooms, is there like an emergency button?
I'll be honest, you lost me at boot.
Just the left one.
Carry on.
He's drooling.
And he's getting closer. Can you back up?
I'm away,
so is there like an emergency button, like when you're in a changing room?
As far as I'm aware, I don't think I've ever seen one.
All right, so...
In a male changing room.
So in a lot of girls' changing rooms, from my experience, there's a button. So if you need like
really?
A new
Are
size or whatever, you can press it and then the lovely people come and bring you a new size. Or if you need help...
Where do you shop at Gucci?
No, this is
there
actually...
are other stores available. I just remember this is the BBC. There are other designer labels available.
I'll throw another one in there because it was in Topshop. Anyway, so she was saying to me... There's other available for that as well. So she was saying to me...
Stop saying Brad.
Well, you shut up. So she said that she had to press the emergency messy bottom because she got stuck so much in a top that the attendant had to come in with a pair of scissors and cut her out of the top.
Did she have to pay for the top?
No, she didn't have to pay for it because she was mortified. And I think they were so embarrassed for her that they was like, do you know what? Don't worry about it. Just go out red face and leave it.
Is this a friend of yours?
This is a friend of mine. So this is the thing.
Is this you, Giles?
Is your friend Blunt?
Is she from Essex, your friend?
Thing is, she is.
And is that like Charlie?
No, it's not. But I did promise her first show, 81199. If there is anyone out there, one person, just one person that's been in this position, have had to be cut out of a top to make her feel better, or if you know someone, just let us know. I just need one, all right? 81199 is BBC Radio 1. No.
The female MCs are smashing it at the moment. That's Nadia Rose, Aeroplane Mode. It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, Radio 1.
I love you guys already. So one of my friends, just quickly, she had to get cut out of a top when she was trying it on in the changing rooms the other day. I was asking you guys to text in 81199. I just need one person, basically, that's been in the same situation. There are so many. Thank you so much. Someone says, 674, my daughter wasn't cut out of a top, but dislocated her shoulder trying to take one off. But the best thing is, the shop gave her 25% off the next purchase she made. Shout out to Leanne.
So that's how you get a discount.
Keep them coming in.
Crazy. All right, I've got some new music for you guys. This next artist is an American rapper and singer-songwriter. Her name is Lizzo. Now, she's been around for a little while. She released her debut album, Lizzo Bangers, back in 2013, and she's back. She's got a more up-tempo mainstream track doing the rounds at the minute called Juice, but I'm really feeling the vibe on this next track, produced by Warren Oakfelder. It also features one of the most influential artists of her generation. Missy Elliott's on this track as well, spitting bars. She co-wrote and co-produced the song as well. See what you think. This is Lizzo with Tempo on BBC Radio 1.
Slow songs, they for skinny girls. Came get up to the tempo.
Such a tune, Lizzo featuring Missy Elliott. That one's called Tempo. It's BBC Radio 1.
Ricky,
Melvin,
Charlie,
one.
Have you ever been stuck in a top, a pair of trousers, whilst changing in a changing room? There are so many shouts still coming in. 81199. I think I found my favourite. 495. Not caught in a shop, caught in a bar. Friend's tight skirt got caught in her top after the toilet. Had to be cut out of it by the barman and went home in football shorts.
To be a fly on the wall. Right, so guys, I want to talk about something quickly with you guys. I think, Ricky, I've told you about it, but Charles, you don't know.
Oh, no.
So I'm going to share it with the rest of the world. So a little while ago, I decided to try out a new dating app. I was on it for...
Hang on. Backstep. Yeah. When you say a little while ago, as in last night?
No, it was like a few months ago.
No. It was about a week ago. So listen, Melvin comes to me, right? He was like, Ricks. You know when he wants to tell you something important? He was like, Ricks. Nah, seriously, Ricks. I got this new app. It is popping. Yeah. And then he got his phone out, and you know when he does that thing when he flicks his finger from the top to bottom to show you all the people that are coming through? He's like, look at all the girls out here.
Shut up.
He's lying.
Shout out to everyone on Grindr. Living his best life.
I'm living my best.
But can I say, it wasn't for me, so I decided to come off of the app, which you know about.
Why
right?
Wasn't it for you, though?
Just, you spend more time speaking to people than actually meeting them.
Okay.
Right, so I came off the app, right? I was minding my own business the next day, and I get a message from one of my friends. She's like, have you seen this? It was an article from a well-known tabloid newspaper, and they decided to hate on my dating profile with all the things happening in the world today.
So basically, a journalist has seen it, see Melvin's profile on this dating.
But they was also on the app. That means potentially.
Yeah. But these journalists probably go on them just to make sure that if anyone pops up who's in the public eye.
Is this a paying one? Is this the one you paid for?
No, I didn't pay for this one. This was free of charge, right?
So I'm paying David over.
You know what? One of my friends was telling me, one of my friends was saying a little while ago, you was telling them how much you pay for your subscription.
What, she knows how much I pay? Why does she know how much I pay? Why is she my business friend? Anyway, let me tell you about this article. So the headline was, Who's Hat? It's Melvin on app. I mean, what a headline. If that doesn't sell papers, I don't know what.
Say it again.
So, Who's Hat? It's Melvin on app. And then the first line reads, Strictly's Melvin O'Doom appears to be having as much love with his love life as he did on the dance floor. I mean, Why would you need to bring that up again?
It's brilliant. I like this person.
And then they go on to say, Melvin poses in a variety of hats and suits outside a country manor. Posing, you know. What kind of picture are you painting here about me?
The crazy thing is, it can't have done anything to dent his ego because man came to work with a bag full of condoms.
Melvin. Charlie. Woo. On BBC Radio 1. Radio 1 Indie Show.
We're called Hot Chip.
Jack Saunders.
I'm giving away a pair of tickets to see Hot Chip live. Listen tonight from 11.
Okay, it's 10 p.m. Ricky, Melvin and Charlie on BBC
Radio.
Hey! Hour 2. Right, let's get it, people. Come on.
All right, here we go. What happens when you blindfold all three of us, mm-hmm. bring in a mystery celeb, and give us just three questions to try and guess who they are? Shall I tell you?
Go on.
You're going to find out in a minute. It is called Out of Sight and Out of Mind, and it is coming up after Kalani with Feels on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, Radio 1.
How good is this sounding? Kalani Feels on BBC Radio 1.
Three questions, two guesses, one celebrity guess.
This is Out of Sight, Out of Mind.
So right now we're playing Out of Sight, Out of Mind.
Yep, yes. That's right. Each and every week our producers blindfold us and bring a mystery celebrity. It's our job to work out who the celebrity in front of us is.
Yeah, we each have three questions and two guesses to work out the guess. Now they can only answer yes, no and kind of. So guys, are your blindfolds up the ready?
Yep.
All right, we are playing next. It's Radio 1.
Nine minutes past 10. Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, we're here till 11. In the background, sounds of Hardy Caprio, sponsored on BBC Radio 1.
Three questions, two guesses, one celebrity guess.
This is Out of Sight, Out of Mind.
Okay, so right now it's time to play Out of Sight, Out of Mind.
Yes.
Yep, that's right. Our producers are about to bring a mystery celebrity into the studio. It's our job to work out who that celebrity is with only three questions and two guesses each.
All right, boys, we've got our blindfolds on our heads.
Yep.
Hang on a sec, put them over your face.
Okay.
Are we ready?
Ready. Yep.
Producer man Sammy, bring in the guest.
Right, so guest, take a seat, please. Let me see if I can smell you.
Any aftershave or perfume?
Can you smell anything?
No.
Can't smell nothing. Anything yet.
They must have showered this morning.
Okay.
And put no aftershave or no perfume on.
Hello, guest.
How you doing?
Oh, this is brilliant.
How are you?
I'm good.
All right.
Okay, first question is, do you work in music?
Yes.
Oh, straight yes. in with a yes, Rick.
Come on.
Are you a singer?
Yes.
Oh, I wish I could high five you, but I can't see you.
Well done, Charles.
All right. Are you under 30?
Good.
No.
Right. That was handy, Charles.
That was handy.
Okay, next question. Have you had a top 10 single in this country?
Yes.
Yes!
That's a great question.
Oh, gosh.
All right, have we met you before?
Yes.
No! Ooh. Oh, now this is exciting. Okay.
What about features or anything?
What, as in, like, does he have a beard or something?
Like, no,
no, you
I
mean
like...
single.
Oh, what?
I thought you meant facial features.
Do you have eyebrows?
I thought you meant facial features.
And do you have eyes? How about teeth? Do you have lips?
Oh, that's the best question. I'm not using that question. Okay, so are you from South? Are you South of the UK?
Yes.
Ooh.
Oh, come on, we're going to get you. We are going to get you.
South of the UK.
They're not saying nothing else. Like, yes.
That's what no. I like, though.
Sounds like a Jedi. Yes.
Yeah. I've got an idea of who it might be.
Okay.
Go on.
So I want to eradicate that person. You'll know who it is mm-hmm. from okay. this question. All right, so next, my last question
yeah.
To you, guest, mm-hmm. Is, did you have a single kind of like a comeback single a couple of years ago with Big Nasty.
Is he going to say yes or no?
Why is he laughing?
He's laughing.
Go on.
Yes!
Yeah! Wait.
We know.
I'm a guest now.
Yeah,
keep
guess. Going? We know who it is.
No, guess, Rix.
Are you Craig David?
Cheese. Yes!
Your poker face was so hard. Man was just going, yes. No. You weren't saying nothing.
That was nice, though.
How are you?
I'm so good. How are you guys?
So blessed, man. How are you?
I'm good, you know.
I feel like we're on your show.
New pastures. I love this.
Thank you.
How are you guys feeling? You feel good, though, yeah?
We feel really, really good. Listen, Craig, stick around, Jim. We're going to come back to you in a short while, all right? Give it up for Craig David.
Nah, come on.
Features. 15 BBC Radio 1, that is D Block Europe. Kitchen Kings.
Three questions, two guesses, one celebrity guess.
This is Out of Sight, Out of Mind.
All right, so right now we're playing Out of Sight, Out of Mind, and we're joined by Craig David.
Yes,
what a time. Hello, guys.
I can't believe.
I'm happy for you guys.
I can't believe we asked if we'd met him. How funny.
It's like, nah, but it's wicked. I love it. He's got features. I love that. I can't hear what it was sounding like for you. I don't know what the voice was sounding like.
Really weird.
You sounded like Darth Vader or something.
I was a man.
It was a bit scary.
It was good. It was good.
You weren't saying anything else.
Yeah,
you weren't laughing,
stealth.
Nothing. You just came in proper stealth. Yeah.
Anyway, let's get into this because I love stalking your Instagram page. He's always got the most energy. You always have. So where have you been in the last month? What have you been doing, gigs-wise?
Well, we came back from Snowbox the other day.
How was that?
Well, was wicked.
Do you snowboard?
You know, I didn't get a chance to go on the ski slopes, but like it was the closing of that and everyone was hyped, you know what I mean? Just like, so we did that, the TS5 show there.
Nice.
Getting primed for the TS5 12-week Ibiza residency coming up.
Which I still haven't been to. I need to go to that. So still haven't been, man.
Guys, you know that it's like...
We're coming
always,
up.
It's a phone call away with me. Just let me know.
Online. Like, online, on like social media stuff, just like always going off. Always, it's so good.
Please. Like, if genuinely, if you want to come
we'll
through,
we'll be
I've
there
got
this
you.
Year.
The thing is, we know you shut it down. I remember we had a gig with you. And you were before us, right?
Oh, my
God. And the crowd were going crazy.
I just warmed it up for you.
No. It was on fire, Craig.
You deaded the dance.
when we came on, they were ready to go home. They were like, who are these guys?
Craig David. Don't do yourself like that. Come on.
The biggest cheer we got when we were like, big up for Craig David, everyone. After that, no one cared about it. No one cared.
Now, you also brought your mum out on stage as well on a cruise ship. I mean, that must have been major brownie points there, man.
Yeah, do you know what? It was a cruise ship leaving Southampton. What was that going on? It's maiden voyage. It's like this £1 billion like cruise ship. It was crazy, I have to say. And so I was doing the TS5 set on that. But I was like, Mum, you know you need to be coming through. I mean, it's literally like 5 minutes from where my mum lives. So I was like, you're going to come? Yeah. She goes, yeah. She got all excited about it. She didn't know I was going to bring on stage. But I was like, it was just that moment where I was like, again, I'm in Southampton. My mum's with me. I was thinking, you know, if I can just bring my mum out for a moment just to make that whole event special for her, we're good. And she just loved, her face.
I saw the video on Instagram. Sweet.
Because she thought she was just going to pass through. So she's telling like my aunt and telling a couple of friends, I'm just going to support Craig. And the next thing you know, she's getting pictures taken with the guy, the chairman of the cruise liner. The whole thing's in the paper and the Echo. She's like, I got you. I got you on the manager, mum. I got you. I put you on.
Amazing.
In terms of music, Craig, because I always love hearing what you've got coming up next. Are you working with anyone at the minute? Have you got some stuff coming up that we should know about?
We know you've always got like a back.
Exactly.
Unreleased good music.
Man was making music from day.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I've been backing with Fraser T. Smith, producer-wise. Nice. Yep. So that's been wicked. I've been actually Gary Barlow working with him.
No, is it? Really? That's
amazing.
Interesting.
How did that come about?
Man, he's a G, man. I'm telling you. Like, I think you'll be surprised because like you think, you're going to get around the piano and it's going to be them one of them kind of tunes.
Yeah. Don't tell me you're spitting bars or something.
Or Gary's. Yeah.
When you hear it, because I've been going in with Fraser T. Smith, like I said, so the production side of things is leaning where you want it. I mean, he's just done Dave's executive on Dave's album, done Stormzy stuff. You know the drill. So it leans back into where it needs, but the song and the lyric and where we're going is amazing. So I've been working on singles. An album I'd like to think of this year as well.
Yes.
Nice. So it's just manic. Just having a good time, man. Yeah. Just letting the music flow.
We're happy for you,
what
bro.
What a time
flow.
To be
We're
alive.
So happy for
Great.
You.
But what? Let me.
this, you bastard. This, okay, it's all good about, yeah, you got some tunes, and you got an album, and you're doing some tears, like, great, brilliant. But this is happening in front of me. This is madness. Right. I'm happy for you guys.
Thank
you.
Know what I mean? We love you. Thank you.
Because
thank you so
this
much.
New chapter, always yes. change is always a beautiful thing. It's something fresh and something you can start. So I'm happy for you guys, man.
Thank you. You're like the nicest. He's too nice.
We love Chris. No, but it's real talk. You know, I love seeing people like just having like new opportunities, and you guys have been in this for as long as I've been doing my thing. Do you know what I mean? So seeing you just winning and doing it, I love it, man. I'm happy for you guys, really.
Sweet. So we're seeing him in IB for this year, going to his after party. Throw some good ones in
the house. Definitely going to go TS5 this year.
Please come through on the real. Let's not like,
can we make it happen this year?
You let me know and I've got you.
Yeah, thank you so much.
All right, give it up once again for Craig David, people.
Saw you last night, but did it broad day.
Drake, Meek Mill, Going Bad on BBC Radio 1. Give it up for Craig David as well on Out of Sight, Out of Mind. Where's our producers? Sammy, James, when's the next one? Out of Sight, Out of Mind. How often are we doing it? Just so we get a heads up.
Next Monday.
Next Monday. Okay, cool.
Quality stuff.
Look after that. All right, so loads of shouts coming in as well. 81199. Shout out to Georgia. She says, I cannot wait to see Craig David in Ibiza again this year. Nice one, Georgia.
All right, so we've got some more tunes for you guys. If you haven't already, you need to check out the latest album from Swiss Beats. It's called Poison. It features Lil Wayne, Kendrick Lamar, and Nas, to name a few. Now, I love it when the UK and the US come together. That's my favourite thing in music.
It's orgasmic.
I would have said organic. But you go with that too. And this tune from Swiss Beats and Gigs is a perfect example of that. This is Come Again on Radio 1.
The FA Cup semi-finals.
The noise is quite terrific. Surely the upset cannot happen. Absolutely incredible.
They're through to the semi-finals.
The quadruple versus the dream.
What a cup tie.
It's on the line. Manchester City versus Brighton. Saturday at 5:30 on BBC Radio 5 Live, BBC One and BBC iPlayer.
When I stepped in looking like a snack. The girl damn ready to attack. You know why I want, so give me dance.
Yeah, Miss Banks, Kid A Card Snack. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, Radio 1. We were lucky enough to meet her at the Big Nasty Show a couple of weeks ago. Lovely lady. Why are you going?
What? She is a lovely lady.
That's all I had to say.
Can we tell him the real conversation?
Yeah, go on.
No.
Yeah, I dare you.
No.
Because I don't know it.
No, it was all good. Put it that way. It was all good.
Okay. Yeah.
And big up Mo and Nasty.
Yeah. Melville was like, she's buff.
Shut up, man.
Just shut up. All right, so I feel like a lot of people will know where I'm coming from with this one. Especially, guys, picture this. It's the day when you're finally off to get your haircut at the barber's, right? Probably your most beat-up looking day in recent times. Unless you've got a top barber, then you've got nothing to worry about. So shout out to Jake Games. He's a 23-year-old barber who I saw on Twitter. He rates his barbering skills so highly that he came up with a gimmick on social media so that people would put some respect on his name. Right? Now, he gives away his business cards with a free condom. Now, Jake tweeted a picture of this with the caption, to any guy whose hair I cut, they'll look so good after I'm done, they're going to need this condom. Trust me. But then I thought, unless you're friends with Melvin, he carries condoms in his bag.
Hundreds of them.
Ricky.
Melvin.
Charlie. BBC Radio 1.
All right, it's BBC Radio 1. Ricky, Melvin and Charlie. Now, boys, I thought I needed to bring a little bit of house music show. Now, I've got to say, I had such an exciting week last week in Miami. I was lucky enough to play out there for Miami Music Week. This time next year, we are all out there, all right? Now, this track that I'm about to play went off. It was such a big tune. I'm so excited to play it for you guys right now. This is ADA, The Boys Are Waited on BBC Radio 1.
Come on, Charles.
Melvin, Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
What a tune. Toddler T, Alakai Harley on BBC Radio 1.
Right, so guys, we need to talk about this. So, you watch the show Power, right?
Yeah.
The Sense show.
Love Power.
So, if you watch the show, you would know a character on there called Ghost. It's played by a guy called Amari Hardwick. Now, he looks a little bit like me, like a shorter version of me.
Yeah, you wish.
Just
mate.
Imagine that.
If you squint and have dirt in your eyes.
If you're blindfolded.
Well, he's had a
with a bag over your head. Double blindfolded.
He's had a little bit of a backlash on social media because he was at an award ceremony called the NAACP Awards, right? So he's taking photos with Jay-Z. Mm-hmm. Then he moves across to Beyonce to greet her. He gives her a hug.
Whoa. First, he doesn't he like shake hands with Jay-Z and kind of like...
Well, he's taking pictures.
Yeah, but he I think he shakes hands with Jay-Z first.
Yeah. And then moves across to Beyonce.
Yeah, because he's saying hello to both of them.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. Then he hugs Beyonce, then kisses her cheek, which is fine.
Yeah.
But then he moves in for a second kiss on the cheek and slightly grazes.
What, the other side? So he's gone left cheek, right cheek?
He's on the same side of the cheek, I'm sure.
He kind of kissed her first, but he wasn't in position, so he's shuffled a little bit and then kind of kissed her a second time.
What? You don't go in twice, though, on the same side.
You do if you're Amari Hardwick. Now, initially, I didn't really find an issue with this when I saw the video.
I'll be honest, when I saw it, I was like, oh, that's quite friendly.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. But I didn't think it was an issue. They could be close friends, who knows, right?
Exactly.
But the Beehive are not happy.
Oh, no.
Beyonce's fans are going in on his own social media page.
Really?
So if you go to his Insta page right now, they're going in on him. So there's one message that says, one question, who the hell do you think you are?
Is that on his page?
On his page, right? And then someone else goes, I don't blame you. It's Beyonce, but it's disrespectful. Then someone else goes, Solange is waiting for you in the elevator. As we speak. And then someone else goes, you got a little bit of the honey and then you try to double dip. Basically, you could never go to a Beyonce concert ever again.
Right now, this is Ray on BBC Radio 1. Love this one.
Radio 1 Indie Show.
We're called Hot Chip.
Jack Saunders.
I'm giving away a pair of tickets to see Hot Chip live. Listen tonight from 11.
I'm taking your missus. Nah, brother, I'm joking. All these bad beasts, they preying. Car stepped in looking all frozen. My girl with a back looks lovely. Like she ain't never looking like your ting. Bobo stay busy in a bando. And he told me it's getting all boring. I'm taking your missus.
Taking your missus, you know.
Sounds like you. Your anthem, mate. or want to be taking your missus, and then Ricky comes along and he's like,
you know what? Charlie's not playing.
He wasn't.
I've never playing.
All right, so in the studio with us, we've got Jack Saunders.
Yeah. What's up, guys?
Yes, Jack.
How you doing, Jack? You're
Yeah, I'm good. How was your first show?
Oh, do you know what? It's been fun, man.
You know what? Let us know how was the first show.
Yeah, what do you reckon?
I thought it was amazing.
Oh, thank you, bro.
He's a liar. He's not been listening. He's had his headphones on talking to someone else.
No, I've been in there listening the whole time. Oh, it sounded great. Oh,
thank you, bro.
Thank you.
All right, so Jack, you'll know about our talking point from earlier.
Yeah, I heard this
show.
At the start of the show, yeah.
Things that you can say at the dinner table as well as in the bedroom. Have you got one for
me? Yeah, I got one in the locker. I just burnt my tongue.
Do it again.
I just burnt my tongue.
He's done that before.
Some people spray stuff down there, don't they? So I don't know.
Wow.
Just personal experience.
So what have you got coming up on the show, bro?
Tonight's show is going to be good. Every Monday on the show, we give away tickets to a massive band or artist that are playing a live show across the UK that given week tonight. We've got tickets to see Hot Chip to give away. They're coming back with brand new music. They're doing this little underplay tour around the UK. So basically, venues that they shouldn't be playing are way too small for them, but they're doing it just to get warmed up, get back into
That's
the swing
amazing.
Of things. Whole tour's completely sold out. We have the final two tickets. Your only way in.
Wow.
Love that. Sounds good. All right, make sure you guys check that out. Big up, Jack, everybody.
Cheers, guys.
Yes, sir.
All right, so I've got some new music for you guys right now. This next track is from a new artist hailing from Glasgow, Scotland. I heard about him whilst listening to Jam Supernova from our sister station, One Extra, and this song is absolutely phenomenal. Reminds me of one of my favourite artists of all time, Amy Winehouse. See what you guys think. This is Joseph with Limbo on BBC Radio 1.
For the new. If I give me that drop, won't be nothing like Humpties. Battle boss, once you get dumpy, these ops can't never get comfy.
Kenny 1 and Dave 18, Hunter, Ricky Melvin and Charlie.
Ricky
Melvin.
Charlie.
Radio 1.
All right, so we just spoke to Jack Saunders. He's up next from 11 and he's got tickets to give away to see Hot Chip. Now, boys, I don't want to jinx it, but we are nearly at the end of our first show.
Why would you say that?
We've nearly made it. There's one more button to press and then we're out. So let's give it a practice. Right now, this is ASAP Rocky, Skepta, Praise the Lord, on BBC Radio 1. Press it. Yes!
We did it!
We did it!
Unbelievable! We didn't take them off air.
Yet.
Thanks to everyone that got involved in the show tonight. Nice one. We'll see you same time tomorrow. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie. Did it. Text a message, I don't know.
It's a Tuesday night and we're back. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie. This is our first week on Radio 1. You guys all right?
Yes!
Let's do this!
I mean, I don't know about you guys, I was just chuffed to be let back in the building after yesterday's show.
It's too late, they let us in. Can't take it back now,
got
Charles.
Passes and everything.
The passes word. Just quickly, I went on Greg James's breakfast show this morning to play yesterday's quiz. Now, Melv, you're on tomorrow.
That's right.
Rick, you're on the day after.
I'm on Thursday morning, yeah.
How do you think I'd done?
I heard you did really well.
That's what I heard.
So,
did you cheat, Charles?
No, I didn't. The thing is, you can't cheat because you've only got 90 seconds to answer as many.
Google.
No, trust me, there's not enough time. Wait till you do it tomorrow. Right. But anyway, Georgia's the one to beat. She got 13. I got 10.
So she still beat you.
She's still, you got 13
10 is good though. Round of applause for that. Oh, that's great Charlie. Work, Charlie.
So, Mel, good luck tomorrow, mate. You are going to need it, my friend. Right now, this is Tatiana Blueface on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie. Ricky, Melvin, Charlie on BBC Radio 1.
Minutes past nine, BBC Radio 1, it's us, Ricky, Melvin and Charlie on your radio. In the background, that is Addison Pack, King James from the album Ventura. Love this tune. Big.
Ricky. Melvin. Charlie. One.
So, first things first, how's it going? Now,
thank you.
No, I wasn't asking you. but good to hear, Melv. Now, if it's your first time listening as you missed yesterday's show, then welcome. If you did miss it, this is all you need to know from yesterday's show.
So, just before we came on air, one of our producers went into Melvin's bag looking for post-it notes.
Shall we tell him what we found?
So, shut your mouth.
What did we find, Charles?
We found lots of protection.
Lots of condoms. What is wrong with this guy? He's come to work with a bag full of condoms. Why? Who are you?
Well, to be fair, we have got a big team now. We have got a big team.
You guys, like, wow. You guys.
Okay, can I just say this wasn't planned. We weren't supposed to talk about what was in my bag.
So there you have it, pulling out condoms over there like Mary Poppins does out of her bag. How did you get on yesterday, Melva? Well, when we left and
I'm
then
I'm
going
to tell you about something that happened to me once I went home.
Okay.
After the show, I'll talk about it later.
Usable.
Every single one of them.
It was a late night. There was no time for that.
No excuses, Mel. So we want to ask you guys, what have you found that you wish you hadn't? All right, Rick, you got an example?
All right, so there was one time, going back a couple of years, when myself and Melvin, we were going out somewhere, can't remember where we were going, and we had to stop off at my house to quickly just like for a quick pit stop. Melvin was like, can I use your toilet quickly? I was like, yeah, man, of course you can use my toilet. Now, at the time, my toilet, it was like an ensuite bathroom, it linked straight to my bedroom. So he's come out, he's done his business, he's come out, and I've gone into the toilet because I needed to go as well, and he is absolutely destroyed in my toilet. It was absolutely horrendous.
It's natural.
I don't think I've ever got over that. Ever.
He always brings it up as well. And the thing is, if you go to...
I was scarred,
if
my
If you go
bro.
To Ricky's house now, he doesn't let me use his toilet.
Well, to be honest, when you came to mine that time, when you stayed over, I don't think I let you use mine either.
It was just one time, Rick.
Anyway, we'll take it away from you for once, Mel. Okay. What have you found that you wish you hadn't, all right? Give us a call right now. 03 700 100 100. It's BBC Radio 1.
Came with a tick ting, left with a slim one. Tick ting, left with a slim one. Just cut my X ting loose. If something gets dropped, then the beef might stop. But your neck can't end with truce.
So Drake brought out this guy for his first show in London yesterday. He's Dig That featuring Lowski, No Cap on BBC Radio 1. Keep your texts coming in as well, guys. 81199. We are asking you, what have you found that you wish you hadn't?
Nice one, Charles. And if you've got good speakers, I suggest you turn them up right now because the next tune from Coltrane is an absolute banger. And the singer-producer has teamed up with the sweet sounds of Ray and DJ D's on the next one. And also look out for his new track, Superpowers, which is a collaboration with Gold Link, which should feature on his new EP, Heroine. But right now, this is The Fruits. Turn it up! One.
Your
BBC Radio 1, the one for dance.
One! At Radio 1,
you're never far from the best dance music on the planet.
We've got
Mr. Jam,
Paul Wolford,
Benji B,
Diplo and Friends.
Yeah!
Mac,
Danny Howard,
P-Tong,
Toddler T,
Radio 1's Essential Mix,
Radio 1's Residency,
and many more.
And tonight,
the biggest bass bangers.
Next on
Get Annie Nightingale presents from 1am.
Love this girl, Mahalia, Do Not Disturb. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1. Let's do this.
Ricky,
Melvin,
Charlie,
1.
All right, we're asking you guys, what have you found that you wish you hadn't? 03 700 100 100. So, Kiana, what have you found?
I found my mum's collection of sex toys.
Your mum's sex toys? Whoa. And yeah. Where did you find them?
Down the side of her bed.
And what was the most interesting piece?
It was a cream, actually.
Oh, what type of cream?
Understand.
What type of cream?
I was about 13, but it was like a heating cream.
Oh, okay.
All right. And what's your mum's name? Just shout her out for us.
It's Emma.
Hello, Emma. Right, let's go to Toby. Toby, what have you found you wish you hadn't?
I went into one of its rooms and there was a double-ended dildo.
Sorry.
Quality.
He said it so straight.
And who's the mate?
No, it was one of my mates, my sister's rooms.
And did you open up about the findings? Were you shocked about this?
Well, basically, I was like, hold up, wait a minute, something ain't right.
Oh, Toby, you tell a great story, I love it. Have a good one, Toby.
All right, so we've got loads of texts coming in on this one as well. Keep them coming in, 81199. Shout out to Dino in Warrington. He texted and said, back in the day, I came home from school. I popped my head into my mum's bedroom. Unfortunately, my dad was home and drilling my mum doggy.
Oh, my word.
He said, my mum saw me, but just looked shocked. Oh. My dad carried on drilling for oil. Scarred for life.
Oh, my word.
Big up Dino's mum and dad.
Ricky, Melvin,
Charlie,
on BBC Radio 1.
Y'all know her, right?
Oh. DJ Mustard, Migos, Pure Water, it's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
We've just got a text come through and I just can't bring myself to say it. 81199, what have you found that you wish you hadn't? Shout out to Sean, I can't read that one. Rich, you can do that one, mate.
I'll read it.
Go on, you do.
It says, hi, it's Sean. When I was 10, I walked in on my father having oral with my mother. When I questioned my mother about it, she tried telling me that... She was sucking a splinter out of my dad's thigh.
Oh my word.
I have so many questions.
Well, first question is, did they get the splinter out?
Well, or was she really sucking the splinter?
I thought we all know what was going on. Oh man,
leave it there.
Therapy in that family must be through the roof. Keep them coming in online now. Make sure you keep texting us and calling us. 03 700 100 100 100, and text us 01199. It's Radio 1.
From his latest album, Nothing But Net, AJ Tracy Giggs on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky,
Melvin,
Charlie,
Radio 1.
Okay, so over the last few years in this country, I think there's been an area that's been producing so many UK rappers and MCs that have been breaking through and making an impact in the industry. The area that I'm talking about is Croydon in South London.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, Krept and Conan came from there, obviously. Stormzy, the late great Cadet, who passed away recently, rest in paradise. Nadia Rose, Hardy Caprio, they've all done big things starting out from Croydon, South London. And this next artist is definitely the next one up for me to come out of Croydon. His name is Joe Joey, he's 26. He's teamed up with a vocalist called Jay Unity for this track. Check it out. This is Joe Joey featuring Jay Unity, No Way, on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie.
One.
Vitora.
Ricky,
Melvin, Charlie.
One. Radio 1.
Yeah.
9:38. In the evening, Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, we are here till 11 in the background, Tierra Whack, Wasteland on BBC Radio 1.
All right, so if you heard our show from last night, you would know that these guys rudely went through my bag.
We didn't really.
Well, I asked someone to go.
I didn't.
And I didn't either.
I just got told the information, Mel. Like, don't shoot the messenger, bro. Don't shoot the messenger.
Well, I asked our producer to look for some post-it notes in my bag, and you discovered some...
Not me.
Okay.
Our producer.
But you talked about it.
So I'm saying you, right?
And you discovered some condoms, right? Now, bear in mind...
No, I think you're playing it down a bit. We discovered a truckload. Like, you know when Dizzy Rascal says trailer, truckload of trailers? It was a trailer full.
I want to know how much postage costs to get them to your house.
I'll buy them in person, Charles.
I reckon he went to the clinic to get some food. he just picked up some while he was there.
Anyway, my mum was listening.
Oh, sorry.
So, hello, auntie.
I called my sister after the show because they were together.
Hey yo.
And my sister was like, nice first show, really enjoyed it, but mum wants to speak to you. Right?
Oh no.
So I was like, alright, put my mum on the phone. And then my mum goes, oh, it was a very nice show, but why do you have so much protection in your bag? And I was like, I'm sorry mum, you weren't supposed to hear
that. The thing is, that's a great question. Why do you? Because you didn't answer that yesterday.
Well,
so why do you?
I didn't answer the question, right? And I'm not going to answer it right now. But then she was like, don't use protection. I want you to have babies. She goes, I want some grandchildren.
Aww.
So don't use the protection, please.
Yeah, but the thing is, you got to meet someone first.
You're right. But basically, I realised my mum just wants me to practice unprotected sex. So
well, listen, let's be honest. That's why you got the condoms in the first place, because you were down the clinic, mate.
Why are you painting such a bad picture of me? You're a bad man, Ricky.
Radio 1.
Yeah. Osh, my yay is different on BBC Radio 1. I wanted to play this for you guys because you're going to be hearing more of this kind of sound when I go in the mix for the last half hour of the show every single Thursday evening at 10:30. Nice. I just love the pace of this track, the sounds in it, and I feel like this track is for anyone who's got to get over someone. I'll break down the lyrics for you. He's basically saying, me and you are not on the same level. I love it.
Right now, this is Kojo Funds and DJ Spinel. What do you see on Radio 1?
When you look at me, when you look at me, when you look at me, yeah. What do you see?
Big tune, Kojo Funds. What do you see on BBC Radio 1? It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
All right, so in case you guys didn't know, I am a massive, mahoosive Game of Thrones fan. Now, I've tried to convert Charlie, but she's not having any of it.
I tried twice.
You tried a couple of times, Charles. You weren't having it. I managed to convert Melvin. Now, Melvin's a big fan as well. I was even on the Game of Thrones quiz show last weekend, which was on TV. I think my knowledge is on point, right, Melv?
Yeah, you smashed it, bro.
Thank you, bro. Thank you. So anything Game of Thrones, I like to make sure that I know about. Now, Maisie Williams, who plays the character Arya Stark in Game of Thrones, was on American talk show Jimmy Fallon. So I obviously made sure that I watched their interview, right? I mean, it was great. I watched it. Maisie was chatting away, talking about the show. I was excited. And then she drops an absolute clanger.
Oh, no.
She dropped the ultimate spoiler. Have a listen.
When I found out that Arya died in, like, the second episode, I was...
That's a spoiler.
She accidentally told the world that her character Arya dies in the second episode of the new series.
No.
I was furious. I was devastated. I was broken. Maisie also looks really devastated. She even had to leave the set of the show. The host left the set as well. But then I was like, hang on a minute. Nah, she looked kind of too convincing. Wait a second. And then they came back on stage and said this.
April Fools!
Oh, brilliant.
About April Fools.
Brilliant.
You are so good! Oh, my God!
I could not believe it. They absolutely got me.
Fair
but I wasn't
play.
I wasn't the only one as well. I saw Giggs, UK rapper Giggs. He tweeted the clip as well and he was like, yeah, they got me too. So I'm not the only one. I'm not the only one.
It's Radio 1.
Tomorrow
on Radio 1 Breakfast with Greg James.
I'm going to ask a question. Just say the first thing that comes into your head.
We return to fake Britain.
Make up the name of an imaginary pub. Go.
The Snooty Owl.
Listen tomorrow morning from 8.
Shout out to our producer, Sammy James.
In the mix.
Trying to mash up the mix there.
He's obviously got a favourite.
Yeah. Just play, don't Ricky. Play the rest of us. Forget the rest of us, Sammy. Nice one, mate.
All right, so I've got a shout out to the 6369 on the text, who is absolutely furious right now. I'll explain why. Basically, I was talking about Game of Thrones a little bit earlier, and I played you this clip.
When I found out that Arya died in, like, the second episode, I was...
That's a spoiler.
That was basically Maisie Williams from Game of Thrones, who plays Arya Stark.
Yeah.
Now, she came onto the show and said that what it looked like, she'd kind of like let the cat out of the bag and said that Arya Stark dies in the second episode of the brand new series. However, this person on the text obviously didn't hear everything because they've gone to me. Did you actually just play the clip and talk about it? I just turned on the iPlayer. Regardless if you mentioned spoilers ahead, you've just wasted 6 years of viewing. They are absolutely furious. But this is what you didn't hear, obviously. Play the rest of the clip, please.
Hey, Bravo!
And there you go. They came back afterwards and did announce that it was an April Fool's joke. Don't worry, 6369, it got me too.
The thing is, I've got a feeling they've turned off their radio. They're stamping on it right now.
Forever.
They're probably burning their TV license right now. All right, shout out to our Tune of the Week this week. Each week we're picking a Tune of the Week, which we will give a spin every single day on our show. This week we've chosen Coffee and her big new tune, Rapture. Now, Coffee, she's an 18-year-old singer, rapper, and guitarist from Jamaica. Her last release, Toast, was a huge international success, and Rapture is getting a lot of love over on One Extra.
We've got to say a massive big up to Coffee as well, because she actually tweeted us all last night and said, appreciate the love, thank you so much.
Yeah, man, that was so nice. Let us know what you guys think on 81199. This is Rapture, Coffee on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin,
Charlie.
One.
When them see the lyrical doctor.
We're still here for another hour. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie on Radio 1. It's our first week.
Yep. Yes.
We've got some big tunes for you as well. Let's do this.
Come on. Yeah, man, welcome to hour two, everybody. Hold tight as well. We've got Run RMC on the way, where we pick an old school banger for you guys. All you have to do is choose which one you want to hear. It's as simple as that. Hold tight, it's coming up right now. This is Tion Wayne, Keisha and Becky on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, Radio 1.
Very sexy. Insane, very sexy, Keisha. Becky.
2 minutes past 10, BBC Radio 1, the latest single from Ross featuring Tion Wayne, Keisha and Becky. Big tune.
Yeah, it's a big tune. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Okay, people, so it's time to Run RMC. Yes, that's right. Each week we pick an old school banger and you guys get to call up and choose which tune gets played to the nation on Radio 1. So get calling on 03 700 100 100. Here are our three selections this week. Okay, so I'm Ricky and my choice is Lethal Bizzle's Grime Anthem. Pow!
Check this out. It's your boy Melvin here and my choice is Notorious B.I.G. Juicy, a classic.
Like this.
Charlie here, going in with an absolute IB for Anthem. This is Faithless with Insomnia. So we need loads of you to call us up right now. Tell us which tune you want to hear on BBC Radio 1 tonight. All right, the number is 03 700 100 100. Give us a call now. It's BBC Radio 1.
Bad bees. Bad, bad bees. That's a stupid move.
One. Ricky. Melvin. Charlie. On BBC Radio 1.
What a beautiful tune on BBC Radio 1. Shay, Leah, Cherish. The time is 8 minutes past 10 on a Tuesday night. Oh, I'm so excited.
Sounds so nice, Rickster. Say it again.
No, not too much to a show.
All right, it is time for Run RMC. So you guys get to choose which track you want to hear next. All right, now, Rick's your choice. Lethal Bizzle Pow.
I mean, come on.
It's
come
a big tune.
Come on, YG. Come on.
Melvin, Notorious B.I.G. Juicy, another big one there.
Classic shows.
And I've chosen a Faithless Insomnia. Guys, keep your calls coming in. 03700 100 100 is BBC Radio 1.
Probably the tune that put her on the map. That is LMA, Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
All right, so right now it's time for...
Run RMC!
Myself, Ricky and Charlie have each selected an old school banger, and it's up to you guys to decide which tune gets picked, and your choices were...
Okay, my choice, Ricky's choice, Lethal Bizzle, the grime anthem, POW! Yeah, I'm...
Check this out.
It's Melvin here, and my choice was Notorious B.I.G. Juicy. Oh, my days, what a tune.
And it goes a little something like this.
It was only going to go one way with me. My choice is Faithless Insomnia. I love this. All right, let's go to the phones and see who you guys are going to pick. Kieran, how's it going?
Yeah, I'm good, fine, sure.
Good. Now, what do you want to hear? Lethal Bizzle, Notorious B.I.G. or Faithless Insomnia?
Come on, Kieran.
Notorious B.I.G.
Come on! What are you talking about? I saw you're a man of class.
He's got style. He's got swag. I can't argue with that.
Nice one, Kieran. Right, up next is Liam. Liam, what are you going to go for? Which track do you want to hear?
I'm going to have to go for Insomnia by Faithless.
Yes! It's a big tune. Shout to all the Ibiza-mates.
Great work, Charlie. Great work, Liam.
Nice one, Liam.
Thank you.
See you in Ibiza. Bye,
take
mate.
Take care, man.
Right, OK, let's go to Connor. What are you going for, Connor?
Ciao, is some, please.
Insomnia, Faithless.
Yes.
You've made me so happy right now.
I feel like you didn't care about the song.
You care more about Charlie.
Connor, I love you. This is a big tune. It's Faithless Insomnia on BBC Radio 1.
Oi, oi.
I cannot tell you how happy I am that I got to play this for you this evening.
You're jumping around.
I'm so excited. Faithless Insomnia, BBC Radio 1. I've got a shout out to Pete Tong as well. First time I ever went to Ibiza, it was with my brother, Alex. And I remember seeing Pete Tong play and just going, this is insane. So yeah, big up Pete Tong.
All right, so we've all heard that scenario when two people are really close. Then they decide, you know what would be a good idea? Let's get each other's names tattooed on our bodies.
Bad idea.
Well, I think I can go one better than this, right? And this is 100% real, right? Check this out. So I was sitting at home the other day, relaxing, watching Match of the Day, as I do, when my phone beeped and a WhatsApp notification came through. Now, the name that popped up on the notification didn't ring any bells straight away. So I opened the message and there was a picture inside, right? So I've gone to open the pic and it's a picture of someone's upper leg or upper thigh with a tattoo with my initials, RHW, on there.
Oh, no.
So I thought this was a joke, right? So I replied, new phone, who this? Laugh out loud. Then the person revealed who they were, and it was someone that I used to date a couple of years ago.
Oh, no.
And they genuinely have put RHW,
your initials,
my initials, on the top of their thigh. So I was like, what? Like, why would you do that? And she was like, I was like, are you even seeing anyone? And she's seeing someone at the same time as well.
No,
hold on, wait.
With your initials.
It's not like they're dating someone who
RHW. And it's nothing to do with their new guy.
So basically, she's trying to say she wants you back, bruv.
Well,
hang on. Let's backtrack because it was April Fool's yesterday. So when did she send this?
For real.
No, this was like weekend before last.
So then what happened? What did you say to her?
I was like, why did you do it? And she was just like, why not?
Ricky, one word. Teach me, bro.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie on BBC Radio 1.
1026, JK doing his thing. That one's called Heartache on BBC Radio 1.
So excited to play this next track for you guys. So from Birmingham and Bolton, this duo both have incredible solo careers and have now come together to make some absolutely absolute belters. Now, nice. You're going to recognise the Lauryn Hill sample here too from their EP Hot. This is Hot Like Detroit, That Thing on BBC Radio 1.
BBC Sounds. Every week I bring you a 1 hour chunk of blissed out, beautiful, chilled out music.
The Power Down Playlist.
There's a limit to your love.
And you can get it as a music mix on BBC Sounds.
And
joining us for a four-part special series.
I'm a gay.
And I'm a non-gay.
What?
The Life Hacks Podcast.
Answering questions from the LGBT community in a completely safe space.
Download the free BBC Sounds app for music, radio and podcasts.
Back in the days of my bros and me tape on my throwback. With the good memories that I own, let me tape on my throwback. I miss the young days now that I'm grown, let me tape on my throwback. And let me tape on my throwback. Let me tape on my throwback.
The follow-up to the monster smash Homer and B, that is Unknown T with Crazy Cousins, Throwback on BBC Radio 1.
Right, so I need to play some music from Maverick Sabre. If I could sing like this guy, there'd be a lot of shortball babies running around town.
How do you know there's not already?
I'm sure there's a couple in Ibiza.
Oh, Malia.
His voice is like...
Zanti.
Megaloof.
All right, that's enough, guys.
Nottingham, Liverpool.
Let's talk about the music. Shut up. Shut your mouth. Now, his voice is like velvet. And his soulful single Slowed Down from the album When I Wake Up showcases this beautifully. Now the production is tight and the icing on the cake is Georgia Smith has paired up with him on this track.
Nice.
Have a listen, this is Slow Down. Nice is that. Maverick Sabre there, Georgia Smith, Carry Me Home. It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Ricky Melvin Charlie 1.
Question for you. What's your thoughts on buying underwear that's already been worn?
I would never do that.
One word, no.
All right, what if it was women's underwear?
Still no.
All right, so...
Ricky's like,
don't be so hasty.
It depends who it is. If it's Halle Berry's, then possibly.
Okay, so there's a girl that actually buys underwear in bulk, and she sells them sometimes for £90 a pair, with prices varying depending on how long she's worn them for.
Hold up, 90 buff.
Yeah, now, the reason why she sells it is to pay for her student fees. So she did have a webcam originally. She used to film herself, and then obviously the guys or whoever would bid on the underwear, and then she'd put it in the post. So, what's
she
your thoughts on
the
that?
Underwear before
no,
she
so she
it.
Gets more money for the more time she's worn them.
Yeah, I think that's the point. I think the more soiled.
I don't know so much about this.
I think the more soiled they are, right. The higher the quality. So I've heard.
Well, listen, right.
Why do you know
the
so
higher
much?
The premium of the underwear.
So if it's clean, then it's worth.
It's worth nothing. So this is what I thought, right, Melv? I thought I'd treat you. Now I've worn these 15 times, Kat.
No! She threw a nigga at him.
Oh, what do you reckon they were for dinner?
The thing is, all I can spend is Bay Frentos.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie.
One.
Coming up tomorrow
on Radio 1 Breakfast with Greg James.
I'm going to ask a question. Just say the first thing that comes into your head.
We return to Fake Britain.
Make up the name of an imaginary pub. Go.
The Snooty Owl.
Listen tomorrow morning from 8. That
good day. It's Ben Aboy, Dan Gote, BBC Radio 1, Ricky Melvin and Charlie. A massive shout out to 474 who's just said wrong and then laughing his head off. If you've just tuned in, I've just thrown a pair of knickers at Melvin. That's all you need to know, really. Listen back on BBC Sounds.
We should leave it in here for Greg James to enjoy.
That's a great
morning.
Shout.
Yeah, leave it for him. With no explanation.
No, nothing.
All right, so Tiger came out with a new song not so long ago, which to me, I think Tiger's found his lane because most of his songs sound the same. Taste sounds the same, like Swish, sounds like Dip. But this one is produced by DJ Snake featuring Rich the Kid and G-Eazy. Check it out right now. Girls Have Fun on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky,
Melvin,
Charlie,
BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1, Little Sims on your radio right now. That is 101 FM.
Right, so if you follow the rapper Drake, you'll know that he's a big fan of the TV show Top Boy.
Yes.
Now, for ages he's been saying he's going to bring the show back. He even tweeted Ashley Waters in 2014 to say that he loved his performance and he's a big fan of the show as well and bigs up the whole show.
Which was a massive deal at the time,
right? We loved the show. We've all watched it as well.
Yeah.
Now, he bought the rights from Channel 4 to bring it to Netflix, but we weren't too sure when it was coming back until now. So as you guys know, he's on tour at the moment in the UK. A lot of the DJs from Radio 1 have gone down to see the show. So I think Annie Mac's gone, Grimmy's gone over as well.
Yep.
It sounds like a big show. Ricky, you're going on Friday, right?
Yeah, fingers crossed that all still goes through and they don't take my ticket away.
Yeah, good luck.
Well, he debuted a screening of the first trailer for the new series, Series 3 of Top Boy.
Nice.
Now, I think there's going to be some old faces from the original series. So I believe Ashley Waters is still in it. Kano's in it as well. Bashy as well. So that's big news. But there's also some new faces. So Little Sims, who we just heard is going to be in the new series.
Amazing.
And rapper Dave.
So Dave's going to be so good. Well.
Huge. And it's out in autumn. So look out for that. It's going to be massive.
Yeah, man.
It's Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1, Ricky Melvin and Charlie in the background, Travis Scott, Butterfly Effect from his album Astro World 2018.
All right, Jack Saunders is up next with Radio 1's indie show. It's a wicked show, love it, go and check him out. And he's got live tracks by Bodega recorded at Made of Out as well. Right, we will see you guys same time tomorrow, 9 p.m. on BBC Radio 1.
Jigga. Another guilty beat.
Jigga boys.
Here we go, Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, BBC Radio 1. You good, boys?
All good, Charles.
Great, Charles.
Should we do this?
Yep.
We are here until 11.
Right, you good-looking bunch. This is your show too. Call us anytime on 03 700 100 100. We've got some amazing tracks for you lot tonight. We're going to start with this one. This is Roddy Ricch, Chip, Young Bane, The Plug, How It Is on BBC Radio 1.
Yep, yep,
do
yep.
It.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, Radio 1. Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, on BBC Radio 1.
One of my favourite Kalani songs ever, that's Nights Like This on BBC Radio 1 featuring Ty Dolla $ign from the album While We Wait. Now, the average person will wait in a queue for 6 minutes before they get absolutely irate.
That's a long time, though. If you think 6 minutes is a long time.
Yeah, 6 minutes too long for me.
Melvin. Charlie.
All right, so today we want some real stories. Today we're talking about if you've dated someone and then realised you fancied their friend more. Now, I think everyone's been in this situation at least once, but some people act on it, others just suffer in silence. Now, I want to say I'm not proud of it, but this has happened to me before. Shock horror.
With who though? A parent or a friend?
Well, I was dating someone, right? And then we broke up. A few months later, I was out and about. Yeah. And I bumped into this young lady, lovely, we got on really well, she was amazing. And then in the middle of the conversation, she basically explained that her best friend used to be my ex. And I was like, why didn't I meet you first? I wish I had a time machine.
But see, that was a very, very, like, you know, like, boring story.
A very watered down version of it.
There was one time me and Melvin were DJing. Melvin's gone to me, oh, I met Ricks, meet my two friends. So he's got these two girls with him. So I was like, oh, okay, Melvin, who are these? And he was like, oh, remember that girl that I told you I was dating like last week? This is her friend as well, but I like her more.
No,
I said to him, listen, Melvin, don't be hasty. Like the one that you've got from before, she's really nice. But what did Melvin do?
He was greedy
and he tried it on with both of them.
And they both ended up with Ricky at different times.
That's a true story.
A better story, but I didn't want to share that one. But I mean, Ricky's done it anyway. Fair enough. So I want to find out from you guys, have you ever dated someone and then realised you fancied their friend more? Did you act on it? Did you say nothing? And also, it could have been maybe like a family member, like their dad.
Well, do you know what,
brother and sister?
I'm going to throw one in there. So I'm not going to name this person. However, a few years ago, you will know the person, do not name them. Mm-hmm. Their dad was actually much better looking, and obviously I was going out with the guy and I wouldn't have gone for the dad, but I mean, he was a 10 out of 10.
Yeah, I used to, like, my old ex-girlfriend, she used to wind me up all the time and say she fancied my dad.
Your dad is
good looking though. He's better looking than you.
Yes,
as well.
I know this. Much better looking. Which is why I cut me
deep. I don't know what happened with you, bro. Like, it went the other way. Anyway, so guys, we want to know your stories.
You
have you ever fancied your partner's friend more than your partner? Call us right now, 03700 100 100. It's Radio 1.
Oh, yeah.
It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie on BBC Radio 1. That's Ariana Grande and Victoria Monet, Monopoly. Now that tune's already had 8 million views on YouTube in 48 hours, big. And we're still asking you guys, have you ever fancied your partner's friend more than your partner? We're going to get into that very soon.
Yes, we are. Now this next guy that I'm about to play you is a very good friend of all of ours. It also helps that he's making massive tunes too, which is why I want to play this for you guys right now. This is the big one from Majestic, I Want to Be Down, on BBC Radio 1.
Fake Cup semi-finals.
The noise is quite terrific.
Surely the upset cannot happen.
Absolutely incredible.
They're through to the semi-finals.
The quadruple versus the dream.
What a cup tie.
It's on the line. Manchester City versus Brighton. Saturday at 5:30 on BBC Radio 5 Live, BBC One and BBC iPlayer.
Big tunes on BBC Radio 1. Heady One, of course. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
Ricky.
Melvin.
Charlie.
One. Right, so today we're asking you guys, have you ever fancied your partner's friend more than your partner? Have we got anyone in text, Ricks?
Yeah, shout out to the 6616. Says, I got with a girl after a night out. 3 months later, I was in a relationship with her sister.
Wow.
We had no idea until a very awkward first night over when I got invited over for dinner with both of them and their parents.
If you're listening right now, call us because I want to know what that conversation was like around the dinner table.
How did he get away with that?
Well, maybe he didn't.
We need to know.
That's Cal on the 6616.
Well, he still went to dinner with the family, so...
But that's when they found out.
Oh, serious?
That's why that person right now needs to call. We want to hear that conversation around the dinner table.
All right, shout out to the 5380. Says, all right, Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, a mate of mine fancied this girl, but when he tried it on with her, she was having none of it. 4 years later, I'm still with her. From Chris. Savage.
Well, guys, keep your calls coming in. 03700 100 100. We're going to get into your calls very soon. It's Radio 1.
I'm taking your missus. No, I'm taking your missus.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie.
BBC Radio 1.
Bit of you, Mel. Freaky. You like a bit of freakiness, don't you? Tory Lanez, BBC Radio 1. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
All right. So tonight we're asking you guys, have you ever fancied your partner's friend more than your partner? So we've got an anonymous caller right now.
Yes.
That means it's going to be juicy. Bruv, what's your story?
Well, currently, my missus, I'm not being brutal, she's 3 out of 10.
What? Honestly. How dare
you? You can't say that about your missus, bro.
Well, he said it. Continue the story.
She can't cook. She's a gorgeous girl, but that's it.
You ain't going to have one after this, let me tell you that.
Basically, we're on a night out with her mate. Mm-hmm. Anyway, one of her best mates, she is amazing, 10 out of 10. She got the breast, she got the body, she got the body, she got everything.
This can't be real.
This is your missus's friend.
My missus is 8 and she's 10, what the hell?
Well, listen, it sounds like she's a good 8 there, bro, so stick with her, yeah?
Hopefully.
And anyway, you'll be dumped after tonight.
I say roll the dice, see what happens.
Take that back right
nice
now.
Nice one, Craig. Take care, brother.
See you later, Craig.
Peace. Bye, Craig.
Let's go to line number 2. Hello, Radio 1, who's that?
Craig, can you hear me?
All good, Craig. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm good.
So have you ever fancied your partner's friend more than your partner?
Well, like my text, the opposite thing happened with me. I really liked this girl when I was in college, and I arranged to go on a night out, and me, her, and her friend came out, and some other people, and as it turned out, only me and this friend of hers turned up, and then that night, me and her ended up sleeping together, and then she got together for a year afterwards.
What?
A year afterwards?
Wow, that was a passionate night.
I mean, you can't fight love, though, bro.
Or maybe fight when you've got the connection. You have to go.
I don't like this conversation. I don't know where it's going. I don't like it.
Craig, it's
Craig,
real life.
We enjoyed it, Craig. Thank you for the call.
Yes, Craig.
No problem.
Bye, Craig.
Take care.
See you later, Craig and Wales.
Guys, keep your calls coming in. 83700 100 100. It's Radio 1. I'm putting myself.
What a big tune, Mahalia, Do Not Disturb on BBC Radio 1. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
Yeah, man. Okay, so this next track is by a Belgian producer and DJ called To Die For, known for his electronic beats. He's linked up with another producer called Shuba and a vocalist called Romeo Elvis, and they've come up with this infectious track.
These names,
what
Rick.
A great
it's phenomenal, right? Phenomenal name.
It beats Melvin O'Doom.
Let us know what you think of this one on 81199. This single's called Signals on BBC Radio 1.
Yeah, come on. When I look at you,
Ricky, Melvin,
Charlie
on BBC Radio 1.
So join Drake at the O2 on stage last night. That's gigs, baby. It's Ricky, Melvin, and Charlie, Radio 1.
Ricky,
Melvin,
Charlie,
1.
All right, so I want to talk about things that us girls do that we don't think other girls do, but we do. Are you with me? Do you want me to go over that again?
Go on.
All right, I'll say it again. Yep. Things us girls do
yep.
that we don't think other girls do,
right.
but we definitely do. So I'm going to give you a few examples.
Can I guess one of the things that you do, Charles?
Go on.
Do you like sniff your armpits? I'm sure I've seen you do that before.
We've definitely seen her do it. Like, and she tries to do it in a movement that looks like she's not doing what she's doing. Yeah. So she kind of like uses the palm of her hand, like her fingers, and then kind of wipes underneath her armpit.
Right.
And then goes to like, she sniffs it as she moves
it's
her hand.
It's like her hand across her face.
Yes.
Listen,
yes.
If you want to talk about wet wipes, I'll take you
no,
there.
No, please.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
No, don't do
I
that
didn't
one.
Wow, that story could never come to
no,
air.
Please.
And it wasn't even about me.
But let me tell you, my friend, ever blow me up like that again, and I will tell you about what I'm doing. No, I like it. All right, so other examples. So when I get in the lift, like, for example, I got in the lift today, and as soon as you're on your own in the lift, it's like you look in every hole that's available on your body.
No,
like,
calm down. I know we're past the watershed. There's no need to
we
go
don't want
that,
to know about your holes.
No need to go
yet,
that
and
hard.
And especially not in the lift.
I look in every... As soon as I get in the lift, I look in every hole. Do you really? Okay.
Do you know what? You two are idiots. I'm not even going to give you the last one. Let's get this one. See what I want.
Falling like the keys on a leash shot. Falling like the crumbs from the roof. I think I need to go...
Sounding good on BBC Radio 1. That is Javon Fallin, Ricky, Melvin and Charlie. We are here until 11 p.m.
I've got to say, you guys are giving me joke tonight. We've been asking everyone, have you ever fancied your partner's friend more than your partner? We've got Ryan on the phone. Ryan, you there?
Well, the story goes, it's not my partner's friend. It was actually my girlfriend's brother.
Girlfriend's brother?
Okay, explain.
Yeah, right, so, Being bisexual is actually quite good because my girlfriend, her brother was a lot better looking than what she was.
Brilliant. Harsh, but brilliant.
Living your best life.
I like living life on the edge, what can I say?
Could your girlfriend tell?
No, so I finished with her, and I still see the brother. It's great.
The man likes variety, boy.
I want to be his friend. You sound like a good friend to have.
Absolutely.
Nice one, Ryan.
Thanks, Ryan.
Right, cheers.
See you later.
Take care. It's Radio 1.
Bye.
Still bangles.
What a big tune, Steel Bangles, AJ Tracy, Mostack, Fashion Week, it's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1. This tune is doing bits at the moment, number 7 in the UK charts. Big up.
Doing bits. Bits.
I like to speak like my barber from time to time.
Melvin thinks he's on Love Island. Did
and, a bit. And he hasn't got a barber. We should call him a beer barber. Like a beardy barber. Do you know what I mean?
He's a groomsman, Charles.
All right, check this out. If someone took you guys to the cinema on a first date, what would you think?
Honestly?
First date, cinema. Someone takes you to cinema.
If someone takes me anywhere, I'm happy. I could go to the park and I'd be happy.
I'm the complete opposite. I feel like they think I'm really boring if they take me to the cinema. Although, I do think if it's a bad date, it's a good place to go, because if the person's not talking, cinema's the perfect thing. You can't talk.
But you see, I don't think the cinema's a bad thing, Charles, because you go to cinema, you watch the film, and if it goes well, then you go
make sweet love.
You have dinner or you have drinks and you can talk about the film. You've already got something to talk about.
All right, well, listen, check this out. The cinema game just went into overdrive. Now, there's a cinema experience that's just been launched in Amsterdam, all right? Now, they're calling it the 5D porn cinema. Now, it features bouncing chairs.
Hold on, let me write this down.
Micro air cannons, as well as a wind and water jet system that is in sync with whatever you're watching to help stimulate the senses. Now, despite this being pretty X-rated, the owner of the cinema said that they think it's actually a great place to spend with your loved ones, more like an amusement park. So I thought to myself, what would you call an amusement park like that? And the only thing I could come up with was Busch Gardens. But text us on 81199. Let us know right now, though. This is Odunsi featuring Ray Tipsy on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie.
BBC
Radio
1. Coming up tomorrow
on Radio 1 Breakfast with Greg James.
More things we should have known sooner.
The Fact Controller with special guest Joe Lycett.
1.
Tomorrow morning from 7:30.
I see you on 10 toes, G. Don't say that you know me. Tuck your chain and roll me. 'Cause this is the night side.
Beat Freaks.
Loving this one, Swarms, Tion Wayne, Bally on BBC Radio 1.
All right, so I somehow managed to get onto the topic of trying to find a name for a porn theme park.
I love it.
And loads of people are getting involved in this. First, I've got a shout out to our producer, Ollie, who said, Chestington World of Adventures, which is one of my personal favourites. Loads of people getting involved. Shout out to the 4427, who says, Wet and Wild. Shout out to 0923, you're going to like this one, Melvin, Squirter's Palace.
Oh,
shout out to 6547, said, these are all Florida themed. She says, Tap That Bay is in Tampa Bay,
yes.
Or Flow Ride Her.
I love that.
I quite like that one as well.
I've got another one.
Go on, Charles.
I've got two actually, but one of them my friends just messaged in. I don't feel I like it. I don't feel I should say the way. This is my one.
Go on.
Every ride's free.
Every ride's free.
Yeah, because like when you ride, it's for free.
Why
and the,
not?
And the next
well, who's
one,
paying for their rides?
Well, the fact is that they are free. And my friend, shout out to Lara, says Minge Mountain.
Minge Mountain.
I like it.
Disgusting.
I do enjoy that one. Well, let's take it down a little bit right now with a track produced by one of our favourite producers, Kate Renata. Now, as soon as you hear that name, you know this tune is going to be an absolute problem. Now, he's teamed up with a Canadian-based singer called Shay Leah, who you may have heard on his album 99.9%. Now, before we play this track, if you're at home right now and you've got some company, you can thank me later because things are about to get sexy. This is Cherish.
Oh, please don't ever do that again.
Cherish.
It's BBC Radio 1.
Love this tune. Shay Leah, Cherish. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Okay, so we're asking you guys for the names of porn theme parks, or if you were going to name a porn theme park, what would you call it? Let's go to the phone lines. Hello, Dave, you there?
I have, yeah, and it's based on a theme park that's actually closed now.
Good.
Camelot Park.
Who?
Say again.
It was called Camelot, but I was thinking either Camel Toe Park or Camelot Park. So,
I already want tickets.
I think they're both work, to be fair.
Thanks for your call, Paul. Nice one, mate.
See you, Paul.
No problem, man. Bye.
Take care. Minutes past 10, BBC Radio 1, Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, we are here till 11. That is UG in the background with Melvin. Say how you just said it.
No.
Lovely.
One. Don't go there.
So right now it's time for Don't Go There.
Yep.
So one of us is about to have a terrible, embarrassing story told about us live to the nation, but who's it going to be?
All right, so let's be honest. We have a lot of dirt on each other, don't we? Now, many of these stories have never been told on the radio, but that is about to change. There's only one rule. There's no holding back.
I mean, if I have my choice, I know who I'd go for tonight. I'd go for Ricky Hayward-Williams.
And I would go for Charlie Hollywood Hedges.
Just anyone but me, please. Okay, so guys, ready?
Yeah.
Okay, computer, please tell us who is today's victim.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie,
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, Melvin, Charlie, Ricky.
Is
Oh, it's Ricky!
Listen to how happy Melvin sounds. Oh. Charlie threw her hands in the air.
It is a...
Charles, it's a good day.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Can you taste the victory? Well, Ricky, you've got two songs to mentally prepare yourself for the one of the most traumatic tales to be ever told. Ladies and gents, grab yourself some popcorn and enjoy.
And make it a large one, my friends. It's BBC Radio 1.
Be gentle.
S to the T. Sigma.
The big one from Miss there. Can't stop clocks. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
All right, so guys, I am massively excited to play you this next track. Now, Jack Back, aka David Guetta, has been making some amazing new tracks under his new Deeper House name. You'll recognise the sample used in this one as well. He took over Danny Howard's show a few weeks back. You can check that out on BBC Sounds. Let me know what you think of this one. 81199 on the text. This is Jack Back Survivor on BBC Radio 1. Big tune! I mean, if your radio is not turned up right now, there is something wrong. This is such a big tune. Jack Back Survivor on BBC Radio 1.
Don't go there.
Okay, oh my days.
Hang on, Mel. Listen, take it easy, yes, my friend. Take yes, it slowly. Charles. Enjoy every second of it.
It's just I'm so excited, Charlie. I'm so excited. So it's time for Ricky to receive a dose of don't go there medicine.
Listen to how happy he is.
How's now, it taste, Rick? How's it taste?
How's it tasted?
Salty.
Now, bear in mind, it's not our fault. The computer randomly selected you to be exposed by myself or Charlie, so we're going to basically tell an embarrassing story about you. Is there anything you'd like to say, Ricky, before we begin?
All I'm going to say is, if you cross the line, I'm taking you down with me. I don't know how, but I will take you both down with me.
Okay. Charlie, may I do the honours on this?
I mean, Melvino, I tell you what, you take it away and I will help you as and when I can.
Let me just click my fingers and get ready.
I'm going to sit back and put my feet on the desk.
Now, this story does involve me. And I've got to say, Ricky, you took one for the team, but you really pushed the boundaries on this one. So myself and Ricky had a gig in the middle of nowhere, right? And it was quite a long drive. It was quite a rainy night as well. And Ricky at the time was obsessed with the TV show 24. Now, Ricky is the worst passenger in the world because he sat beside me for the whole journey. It was about 3 hours. And he sat beside me for the whole journey watching 24
on
his laptop.
You are boring, though.
I'm boring.
In the car.
But at least make some conversation with me. He had his headphones on, so I couldn't speak to him. And I drove for 3 hours. We got to the hotel,
that's
right?
Bad.
And the promoter had booked us a hotel. And I had a friend that lived in the same area, and she was supposed to meet me and stay with me at this hotel, right? So we go to the guy on reception. We're like, Ricky and Melvin, can we have our room keys, please? He goes, yep, here's your key. And we're like, no, room keys. It's Ricky and Melvin. I've got this friend coming to the hotel, so I need my own room.
When he says friend, guys, we know what he means.
He means concubine.
No, I don't mean that, right? So as this receptionist gives us the key, one key, my friend walks through the door, and Ricky starts laughing because we then realise we all have to share a room together. So I'm... You know, we get to the room and I'm quite...
Basically, just get on with it. Basically, Melvin starts getting a bit of action is where we need to go.
Well, Ricky, being the guy that he is, said that he will agree to sleep in the...
I said, first of all, I was like, you know what? I'll go and sleep in the car. I'll go and sleep in the
car.
That
yes. What he said? That's yeah.
But it was freezing outside.
It was freezing and it was raining. And Melvin was like, no. I can't let you do that, Rick. I can't let you do that. I'll tell you what you could do instead.
You can sleep in the wardrobe. So he took his laptop and he's 24 and he slept in the wardrobe for the whole night.
But to be fair, Melv, when you say whole night, don't lie, mate.
Yeah, I was in there for a couple of minutes.
I heard it was 30 seconds later. Yo. Ayo, toddler. I'll tell him. Yo. The T, Alakai Harley, Instruction tune. On BBC Radio 1. Big tune.
Guys, can I do my pun, please?
Are you still going on about those puns, man?
Yeah, the porn theme park puns.
This better be good, otherwise...
Now, bear in mind, it's taken me ages to come up with this.
And bearing in mind, the listeners have been sending in some absolute gems.
I'm proud of this one. All right. I'd like to share it. It's called Pregoland.
Where Melvin goes every single season.
Wait, Pregoland?
Yeah, Like Legoland. But you make everyone pregnant.
I think we got it, Rob. I don't think
all right,
need
I didn't need, need any explanation. All right, but that's what I was going for. I'm happy with that. I don't know about you guys. And hope we get season three.
He's like, he's shuffling these papers like he's just finishing the news, like, tapping them on the table.
Have we got any shouts?
Yeah, what we got?
Oh, there's a few shouts, man. Hold on. We've got from the 0412, Drayton Man Whore Park. That's quite a good one. We've got from the 2750, Spunkton Towers.
Wow.
That's from Jess and Max in Bristol. And the other one, I definitely can't read on the radio.
Okay,
all right, we'll say keep them coming in. 81199. It's Miss Banks on BBC Radio 1.
Big up the Splurge Boys on the production on this one. That is Miss Banks, Hood Chick on BBC Radio 1. The time is 22 minutes past 10.
Ricky. Melvin. Charlie.
One. All right, so each day this week, we have been playing the new one from Coffee, which is called Ratchet. It's a big tune as well, boys, ain't it?
Yeah.
Now, Coffee performed this morning in the One Extra Live Lounge, which Annie then played on her show earlier on tonight. Now, you can listen back to that on the BBC Sounds app. But right now on Radio 1, this is Coffee Ratchet. Our tune of the week.
BBC Radio 1, the one for dance.
One!
At Radio 1,
you're never far from the best dance music on the planet.
We've got
Annie Nightingale,
Mr. Jam,
Monkey,
Diplo and Friends.
Yeah!
Annie Mac,
Danny Howard,
P-Tong,
Toddler T,
Radio 1's Essential Mix,
and many more.
And tonight,
next on
the best in dance, hip-hop and future cuts.
Get Benji B from 1 a.m.
Radio 1, Dave Burner Boy, location, Ricky Melvin and Charlie, we're here till 10, 11 even.
Nearly.
Ricky nearly finished early, boy. Right, so the latest thing to trend on Twitter is irritating responses that you get from people when you say your name. For example, if someone tells you their name's Ollie, I can't help but say, oi, oi, oi.
Yeah, I know.
I can see in their eyes they're upset, but I have to say it. Someone called Ruby Summer on Twitter hates when she gets the response, Ruby, 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 Ruby.
Oh, I love that.
I like that. That's got to be done.
Yeah, that's good.
Joy on Twitter gets, what response do you think she gets?
What's her name, Joy?
Joy. What do you think she gets? Give up?
Yeah. Give up.
Joy to the world.
Oh, no.
And Adam always gets, where's Eve? So I want to find out from you guys, what irritating responses do you get off the back of your name? Let us know on text 81199. It's Radio 1.
Ricky. Melvin. Charlie.
BBC Radio 1.
Come back at it. She never made love, but she good at it. I get goosebumps when I look at it.
Look back at BBC Radio 1. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
All right, so I've been asking you guys on text, what irritating responses do you get off the back of your name? There's so many texts come through on 81199. Shout out to Donna, who gets Donna Kebab. Jake gets Jake the Peg with the extra leg. Payne gets Painkiller or Pain in the Butt. Scotty gets Boo Me Up, Scotty.
I like that
and
one.
Jenny gets, of course, Jenny from the Block. Love those.
Keep them coming in, 81199. All right, some new music for you. Played it yesterday on the show. This is Lizzo featuring Missy Elliott. She's an American rapper, singer-songwriter. She's teamed up with Missy, who helped co-produce it as well. It's Vibesy, man. Check it out right now. Lizzo, Missy Elliott, Tempo on BBC Radio 1.
Slow songs, they for skinny girls.
So there we have it, Lizzo featuring Missy Elliott. That one's called Tempo on BBC Radio 1. Love that tune.
And we're still asking you guys, what irritating responses do you get off the back of your name? 704 gets, my name's Theo. So everyone shouts out Walcott. Is that a football joke or something?
Oh, Theo. Oh, how do you... Oh, do you know, don't even explain it to him.
To be fair.
Who's he play for?
Have a guess.
Tottenham?
Arsenal.
Okay. Close though, wasn't it?
He was close. He was
very close. Carl gets Jezza or Jeremy, and Storm gets Lo. She gets, were you born in a storm or are your siblings thunder or lightning. Like those.
They must hate that so badly. All right, so a blogger from the States is so fed up with her fella being lazy. She says he literally sits on the sofa all day that she made a fake shopping list that doesn't exist, sent him off shopping with this list of things that don't exist, and then turns her phone off, right? Now, the test is, would you two, Ricky and Melvin, fall for the things on the list? You need to tell me what you think out of this list is true or false. Okay. All right, do they exist or not?
All right.
3% milk.
3% milk? What do you mean 3%? So what's the other percent then?
Well, this is a thing. This is one of the things on the list.
Well, I suppose you can get like coconut milk and like almond milk.
But can you get 3%?
No, you can't get 3%.
No, you can't. So obviously he didn't come back with that.
Melvin was doing his long multiplication, doing his sums, writing it down.
Never multiplied by carrying 4.5.
The one. I was never good at maths.
All right, the next one. A tuna eyeball.
A tuna eyeball? Well, yeah, they got eyeballs, so yeah.
Yeah.
Gamma that, Rixer?
I'm going to say no on that one as well.
That's true.
Really?
From Japan, apparently.
Oh.
Unsour cream. This was on the list.
Unsour cream? That's stupid. No, that's not real.
I'm going to say yes.
No, it's fake. You can only get sour cream, my friend. Two more. Diet Coke.
Diet Coke?
Did you not heard about that?
No, so it's like a Diet Coke, but
you know, like a Diet
but less sugar than Diet Coke. Yeah, I believe that one.
You'd have been in so much trouble with this list. It don't exist. And the last one, a yak penis.
A what?
A yak penis.
Your yak needs to make love, though.
Does it exist or not?
I'm going to say no.
I can tell you, my friend, it does in China. I've had it, and it is delicious. BBC Radio 1.
Not just in China.
Hanging around villains and monsters. Big Benzos, not Hondas. All of the men are imposters.
Coming up tomorrow
on Radio 1 Breakfast with Greg James.
More things we should have known sooner.
The Fact Controller with special guest Joe Lycett.
One!
Tomorrow morning from 7:30.
BBC Radio 1, Low Ski, Live Like That. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie.
Ricky.
Melvin.
Charlie.
One!
All right, so this morning I was lucky enough to be on Greg James's breakfast show to play yesterday's quiz.
Yes.
So basically, it's like a general knowledge quiz about the day before. Now, Charlie did it on Tuesday. You scored 10 points, which is great. That's great. Amazing.
It was all right, because I thought I was literally going to score zero.
You smashed it, to be fair, Charles.
Great innings, Charles.
And we had to beat Radio 1 listener, Georgia, who scored 13
She's
points.
Amazing.
How do you think I did?
Well,
You played it down yesterday because I was like, make sure you revise, and you were like, nah, I'm not going to do that. And then you frantically was asking football questions. So I personally think you did all right.
Okay. I think you got 7.
You think I got 7?
Yeah. I'm going to go 8.
I got 9 points.
Oh, well done.
Just one away from Charlie. I was actually quite happy with myself. But I listened back to the show later on, and I listened to my approach compared to Charles's. And I've got to say, I was chilled out. Like, Charlie was playing hard, but I was, like, relaxed, just sitting back enjoying life. Have a listen.
Now, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle joined which social media site yesterday?
Instagram.
Correct. Which London-based football club were relegated from the Premier League last night?
Fulham.
Was you even awake?
I'd just woken up, to be fair. I was very tired.
He sounds so angry.
All right, and this is Charles.
Oh, no. Who played yesterday's quiz yesterday?
George, I was leaving.
Yes, which Take Me Out and new Top Gear presenter was on The One Show last night?
What was that?
It was the crazy frog.
Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness.
So, Rix, you're up now tomorrow.
Yeah,
so
in the morning.
Revision done?
Well, we've been here all day, haven't we?
Yeah, I think Ricky's going to secretly be all right at this game because you've got a great memory.
Yeah, you have.
You're good with, like, the news and facts and figures.
Yeah,
so
I know what he's doing.
I've got
here.
High hopes for you, Ricky.
He's setting me up
if
here.
If you don't beat my score, then it's a shame.
All right, cool. We'll see. We'll see, innit? We'll see.
Good luck, my friend.
Thank you.
BBC Radio 1.
One. Ricky. Melvin. Charlie. On BBC Radio 1. BBC Radio 1 Nav, The Weekend. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie. So,
What have we got coming up after us? It is all about Radio 1's indie show with Jack Saunders up next. He's a good looking boy, Jack, isn't he?
Yes.
He's not. Oh, he's
like
in there.
He's like a slightly taller version of me.
He is it? Oh,
when I look at his face, it's like looking at a mirror.
Like I said, blindfolded with a bag over your head. Anyway, you're right, Jack.
Easy, Jack.
Easy,
going,
Jack.
Mate?
Big up, bro.
Good
big
to
up.
See you. Now, tonight he's got another round of Battle of the Fans. Looking forward to that.
So we've had a fun show today, right? We've talked about so much. We asked you guys if you ever fancied your partner's friend more than your partner. We had the porn feed park names, and then we had the irritating responses that you get off the back of your name. Have we got any more on text, Ricks?
Yeah, so my favourite one at the end of this show is from a guy called Tunde. Now, he says, I overget Tundeo, Tundeo, from Dineo's party hard. He says, I get that from my black friends. He says, from my white friends, I get, Tunde is going to be the day that they're going to throw it back to you.
Wonderful.
Best one so far.
I love it. Right now, this is Little Sims on BBC Radio 1.
Baby, give me your hand, I give it back to you. I'm running out of time.
What's good, people? Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Yes.
What's going on?
Yeah.
How you guys doing, all right?
All good.
All right, man, let's do this. Welcome to Thursday show, everyone. Let's do this.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie.
Right, so guys, today is officially our first full week on BBC Radio 1.
Can you believe it?
Which is great because it's just 4 days.
Yes.
It's perfect.
It's our weekend
it's
now.
It's like this.
Well, we've got another massive show lined up for you guys, and big up Annie Mac for smashing it the last few hours. Yeah, but we're going to keep the tunes coming. And remember, you can get in touch at any time about absolutely anything. It's 81199 on text, or call us 03 700 100 100. But right now, this is Wiley, Steph London, Sean DePaul, Bosey on Radio 1.
Tune.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, Radio 1.
Go!
Ricky, Melvin,
Charlie,
who?
On BBC Radio 1.
Very sexy Becky.
What a tune, Russ, Tion Wayne, Keisha, Becky. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Ricky,
Melvin,
Charlie, 1.
So today, we were all lucky enough to co-host with the ledge that is Scott Mills, as the lovely Chris was off and he got us in to co-host separately. Now, Melv, what did you do with him?
I did a feature called The Great Escape, where you talk about situations where you had to get out of like a one-night stand.
So did you have to give yours?
I gave him like a short one, yeah.
Right, okay. Do you want to repeat or do you rather not?
Do you want to hear it again?
Yeah, why not?
So I was in a situation where I went to like a house party, but it was in the middle of nowhere. So it was like a really big house. And I think the person who owned it was quite well off. So it was like a gated community, right? So anyway, met this person. Then the owner of the house decides to go on holiday at the end of the night. So I met this person, obviously had a few too many drinks. So when I woke up in the morning, realised I made a big mistake and tried to escape, right? But everything was locked down, so I couldn't get out the front door. Then once I finally got out the front door, I couldn't get over the gate. So I had to basically climb over the gate because I didn't know where like the remote was to open it. And that's how I escaped.
Right? I love that. And that's what you done earlier on,
yeah. Like a short version of
that. Perfect. I love it. Ricks, what did you do with him?
I played a game called Bangers, where you both have to nominate just an absolute banger, and then the caller has to call up and then just choose between the two songs.
And did they choose yours?
They did choose mine. Mine was In Paris by Jay-Z and Kanye West.
Get in there. Right, now I got to play a game called Where Do You Think They Were? Now, this is genuinely one of my favourite features, actually. Now, it's where you guys get in touch with Scott and then you call one of your parents, either your mum or your dad, and basically ask them on air where you were made, aka conceived, aka where the magic happened, how the baby was born, how you were born, basically. Now, if you missed today's show, here's what happened.
I was asked to be a bridesmaid at my best friend's wedding.
Oh, lovely.
Uh-oh. And at the time, I had long hair. I decided for the wedding to get a sort of what they called at the time a spiral perm for the wedding, so I could look like Nicole Kidman in Days of Thunder. So anyway, the week before the wedding, kind of disaster strikes a bit because my husband broke his leg in a Sunday league football match. So he looked very handsome on his crutches. We went to the wedding. However, we were not sat together at the wedding because being a bridesmaid, I was on the top table. So I didn't really see that much of him during the reception. But I suppose we were both looking quite good and there was lots of looks across the room.
Oh, yeah.
And it was like a very romantic day.
Cool.
So towards the end of the reception, we got together and we said to each other, shall we go home and shall we have a baby?
Just like that. So there it was. She did it on the carpet. They made a baby and so they were born. Now, it got me thinking, I wonder where all of us lot were made. So basically, I've managed to find out where one of you two were made. I found out where one of you were made. Now,
I'll put it out there right now. I don't want to know.
I'll put it out there right now. I don't want to know, but I want to know where Ricky was.
Oh, I'm so excited. Well, I can tell you.
It's a bit weird, though.
I am about to tell you guys where one of you were made. So you listening, Ricky Melvin, you're going to find out where one of these boys was made.
It's mad that we don't know.
I know.
Such a
Mum.
You wouldn't ask, though.
Mum, come here for a sec. You know that time when your dad made me? When did it happen?
It's a big deal.
I mean, it's not the sort of question that is in my memory bank.
But if that story didn't exist, you wouldn't be here, bro.
Okay, well, who
but
would
I am here, and I don't want to know.
Who would it be worse for? Melv or Rix?
I think it's on par. I'd be surprised if my mum told you.
But it's your mum or your dad.
Yeah, That's true. It could be my dad.
Should we just wait a couple of minutes and then we'll find out who's on the phone, yeah?
I repeat, I don't want to know.
It's too late because we are speaking to someone. It's coming up in a bit on BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
Hello.
Not going to lie, I'm excited about tonight's show. Drake, Nice for What, BBC Radio 1, Ricky Melvin and Charlie. Loads of shouts coming in already. 81199, lovely shout from Vicky. She said, I've never texted a radio show before. Nice one, Vix. Keep listening. Shout out to Adam and his lorry in West Sussex. ECS Southern as well for their night shift. They're listening in. If you just tuned in, welcome to the show, First Things First. All you've missed is basically in a few minutes' time, we are going to find out where one of these two boys, either Ricky or Melvin, where they were made.
I don't want to know, Charles.
It's too late, mate. Too late.
All right, so check this out. Every week we choose a tune of the week, which gets a play on our show each day. Now, our first tune of the week is from Coffee and her awesome new track, Rapture, yes, which is the follow-up to Toast, which you guys would have heard a lot on Radio 1. Now, yesterday morning, she was in the One Extra Live Lounge. So instead of playing the single, we thought we'd play the Live Lounge version. Let us know what you guys think. Text us on 81199. This is Coffee with Rapture, recorded yesterday in the One Extra Live Lounge.
BBC Radio 1, the one for dance.
One! At Radio 1,
you're never far from the best dance music on the planet.
We've got
Annie Nightingale,
Mr. Jam,
Monkey,
Diplo and Friends.
Yeah!
Mac,
Danny Howard,
P-Tom,
Rene Lavoie,
Radio 1's Essential Mix,
and many more.
And tonight,
next on,
check out the madness of the Toddler Tea Shop for all things sound system culture.
Toddler Tea.
From 1 a.m.
Let me tape my throwback.
Such a tune. Unknown T, Crazy Cousins, Throwback. And Unknown T was on Instagram the other day saying, big up Champagne Pappy, who obviously is Drake. And Radio 1's very own Tiffany Calver for bringing him out on Drake's tour on Monday. Big up.
Ricky.
Melvin.
Charlie.
One.
So earlier on today, I played Where Do You Think They Were with Scott Mills. It's where basically you guys get in touch with Scott and then you call your parents, either your mum or your dad, and then ask them live on air where you were made, aka conceived, how you were born. I decided to try and find out where one of the boys were made, either Ricky or Melvin. I've been doing a bit of investigating. I DM'd a few people, got a few contacts, and I have got someone on the line. Line number one. Hello, who are you and who are you related to?
Hi, Charlie. I'm Rose and I'm related to Ricky.
Mum, please don't do this. You don't have to do this, Mum.
Auntie.
You don't have to do this.
Auntie, feel free.
Hello,
and welcome
Auntie
to the
Rose.
Show, Auntie.
Hi, guys.
How are you? Are you okay?
I'm good. He will kill me after this.
Mum, if you have any love for your eldest son, you will put the phone down now and you will never answer it again.
I'm so excited right now. The funny thing is, I spoke to you obviously earlier, didn't I? And I just knew that you would be up for it. So do you know what? I don't think any of us should say anything else.
Okay.
Take it away and tell us where your little baby boy, Mr. Ricky Haywood Williams, was made.
Now, the story's long, so I'm going to keep this short as I possibly can.
I mean, you don't actually have to say anything. You could just say, you could keep it real short and just get off the phone.
See, now, I met Ricky's dad via music, which is where clearly Ricky gets the music influence from. And his dad sort of...
La, 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 la,
Ricky, be quiet. We're listening.
His dad pursued me for, like, forever. And I just remember thinking, if you could take your memory back to, say, 1979.
Oh, gosh.
We don't have to.
When Lovers Rock was really, like, kicking in Britain. Yep.
Get to the point, Mum!
It was happening. And because he was into music, we went everywhere together every weekend. And this particular weekend, we dated for weeks. And, of course, it just didn't happen. And eventually, he took me out. And it was Lovers Rock rocking all night. He took me home.
No!
After listening to all forms of Lovers Rock, and I mean, I can send you a clip, trust me.
No!
Oh my gosh, I love
it! We called it rubbing off the wallpaper.
Oh my God.
I had just left home and moved into
Listen,
my
Listen, this is enough. This is enough. You've said enough.
There was no concern about mum or dad listening in. And we just rocketed. We just did our own Lovers Rock.
Okay.
It was, listen to this, it was...
I don't even know what you're doing right now. I don't want to know.
It was banging.
Auntie Rose, you have made our day.
Thank you so much. This might be the best day of my life. I thought I knew a lot about Ricky, but this was an insight into
something
that has changed my life. So thank you so much, Auntie Rose.
Can I just say though, guys, mm-hmm. he has nothing to be worried about because the Knights of Lovers Rock has influenced his music talent today.
True.
Look at that.
And what's the little saying you've got again about what was it that you did?
Rub off the wallpaper.
That's it.
The one. Hashtag rub off. Let's get that trending. Hashtag rub off the wallpaper.
I can't lie. I'm broken inside. I don't think I'm going to make it back from this.
I'm so sorry, Richard.
It's what I like to call retribution.
Oh my God. You'll never talk to me again, guys.
He will.
I've got to say, you guys got to be good. I didn't think you'd ever be able to get me really good, but this has got to be good.
And it wasn't even April Fool's.
Mum, enough, Mum.
I love you.
Auntie Rose, thank you. We love you loads. Thanks for calling up.
Have a brilliant show.
You take care.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Mum.
And that's how you were made, my friend.
Big tunes, 21 Savage, J. Cole, a lot. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Okay, so Charlie, what you got?
Ricks, you guys are cracking me up. 81199 on the text. We just found out where Ricky was made.
He was conceived.
Laura says, oh my gosh, I wish you'd filmed Ricky's reaction, absolutely howling. Good news is, I think his reaction was filmed, so we'll see what we can do with that.
I mean, it's not going to be hard to imagine it. It was sheer terror. I was horrified.
It was worth it, bro.
Unbelievable. Anyway, listen, last night my cousin went on his third date with this girl that he's been seeing. Mm-hmm. Now, they went to watch Drake at the O2. Now, he's been a proper gentleman up until now. He hasn't even tried to kiss her once yet. However, this morning, he messaged me. He sounded like he was kind of stressed out because the message just read, Ricky, I need to speak to you. Call me when you get this. So I called him. I said, what's up? He said, the date went really, really well. We both really enjoyed the Drake concert. We had a lot of fun. But then he said, at the end of the night, he went to go and kiss her and he caught a whiff of her breath.
Hey.
And it was hammer time. It was, he said it was, he said it was really, really bad. His actual words were, her breath was a problem.
Oh, no.
But I need you guys to tell me, what did my cousin do next? Did he A, turn away and give his cheek at the last minute? Did he B, wretch, because it's not so bad? Mom. Or did he C, suck it up and go through with the kiss?
Wow.
But do you want our answers?
Yes, I'm asking
you. I'm going, he's waited far too long. I reckon he dived in straight for C and he accepted what was in front of him.
Yeah, he's your blood.
So
knowing that, having that knowledge.
He went straight in.
Correct, C.
Yeah.
He sucked it up and went through it like a trooper.
Of course he did.
He didn't mind at all. But I want you guys to let us know. Text us and let us know if you've had any first kiss nightmares. You can text us on 81199. It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Ricky Melvin Charlie,
BBC Radio 1.
Blue face, baby. Damn, bust it, bust it, bust down. Bust down, Tatiana. I
want to
see you bust down.
Over. I got you good, my friend.
Oh, my God.
I can't even back it up. It's probably all right. Blueface, Cardi B, YG, Tatiana, BBC Radio 1.
All right, so Charlie just basically called up my mum and told my mum to give the explanation and give the story of how I was conceived. I'm absolutely broken inside. I'm not lying.
I'm blaming it on Scott Mills because this all come from us doing his show earlier on today.
Big up Scott, big up Chris. Yeah. But basically, the texts have gone crazy about this. And also, we've got a WhatsApp group between our friends. And some of our friends have started to send voice notes into our group. Have a listen to this.
Ricky! From now on, you are called Ricky Rub the Wall, Lovers Rock, Haywood, William!
Sounds like a wrestler.
He sounds like he's like, I don't know, like about to like go for the WWE championship or something. He's that excited about hearing how I was conceived.
Oh, it's beautiful.
That was, do you know what? You guys got me good. I'm impressed.
You're welcome. Impressed.
The thing is, I'm a bit scared now though.
Nah, don't be scared.
Because you guys have raised the bar now. Yeah. So you know what I'm like. I'm going to have to top this up.
Yeah, Ricky's all about the revenge.
It's taken me a long time to get one up on Rickstar, and Charlie, I am enjoying every second
Charlie
of it.
Charlie got me good. So, so good.
Well,
so
it
good.
Was worth it. All right, anyway, up next, I want to play some music from a producer who's worked with the likes of Wiley, Dave, and Young Bane, to name a few. Now, his sound has helped to push grime, Afrobeat, and hip-hop acts into the UK charts. And this next tune went straight in at number 7 in the charts. This is Still Bangles, featuring AJ Tracy and Mo Stack, Fashion Week.
Melvin, Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
My little baby, change up. Sounds of Danny Lee, little baby, BBC Radio 1. Ricky, Melvin and Charlie, we are here till 11. The time is 9:41.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie, Radio 1.
All right, so given the choice when you was like 8 or 9, to take your minds back, prehistoric for some of us.
To the Jurassic era. What a disrespect.
Anyway, if you had a budget of a few £1,000,
right,
which toy would you buy yourself at that age?
See, the toy that I'm thinking of is quite common now.
Okay.
But like when I was a kid, this thing was like, it was the things dreams are made of. So basically a motorized kid's car.
Oh,
which you can get.
Oh, that you sit in yourself.
You sit in yourself because like you can get them really easily now. But when I was a kid, that was the thing to have.
And they weren't cheap either.
No. They're still not cheap now.
Like, no one in my family had one of those.
No.
If someone had that, they were big pimping. They had money in the family. Mine was similar to that.
You should get that instead of your normal car though. It'd still fit you.
He wouldn't have to use his booster seat.
And you wouldn't have to spend money on petrol.
Or cushions either. You know, mine's similar. Mine was a radio-controlled car.
Okay.
Now, I told my dad years ago, but because I wasn't a very clever kid, I asked for a remote
or
control
an adult.
I asked for a remote control car, which means there's a cord attached, so
right,
I had to
okay.
chase the car around.
Yeah, I remember those.
But I went the proper remote control car or radio control car, which was big with the engine, everything.
Yeah, well, listen to this, right? So there's this boy in Sydney. He basically saw a rare toy on eBay. Now, it was a collectible. It was actually a Billy Banana. Now, everyone who wants
a
Billy Banana.
A Billy Banana?
What is that?
Look it up, Melv. You will want one, trust me. There's only 100...
I bet you will.
Sorry, Melv. There's only 100 released in Australia. So his mum's obviously said no, because they're quite expensive on eBay. So what did he do? Goes on his mum's laptop. He uses her card because her card details are already saved on there. Uh-oh. And he spent a mere £7,500. So I'd like to shout out to Billy Banana and that boy's mum.
I don't need a Billy Banana. I've got the Garda Banana.
Oh, hey. Yeah, you wish.
Come on.
BBC Radio.
Who can't do this dance? Options, Tion Wayne, NSG, it's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Try it for me now.
Well, the NSG joke dance.
Yeah,
well, this radio doesn't matter.
It's just, what? Just... I just want to sit for my own... Yeah, you can't do it. Sit down.
What was that?
It's oh like a bad wedding dance.
Just picture Melvin on Strictly. Done.
Too soon, Rick.
Seven. All right, so I basically kicked off my set with this track that I'm about to play you in Miami last week. Mm-hmm. Now, I want to say a massive shout out to Josh Hunter and Be Like Butter, who are on the remix of the version I'm about to play you guys right now. I love this track. I love the pace of it, the sounds, and you're going to be hearing more like this when I go in the mix for the last half hour of the show tonight
with
Club Charlie. This is a big tune. This is Vias' Baby Talk To Me on BBC Radio 1. Thanks so much, Vias' Baby Talk To Me on BBC Radio 1.
Ricky. Melvin. Charlie. Radio 1.
Okay, so I want to speak to the ladies for the just 1 second. Now, when you're looking for your other half, what's the one thing that you want from that person? Is it like strong muscles, a good job, someone funny, someone with hair? I don't have any of those things.
Ah, you got all
I got a job. What do you look for, Charles?
I suppose, like, you want someone that is going to give you some support.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Because, like... Actually, I've got something else, but I'm not saying the other one.
About this. No. What about honesty? Is that important for you?
Yeah, I would say so, to a certain extent.
I'd say loyalty.
Loyalty, yeah. Okay. Well, Charlie, I've got a guy here who might be right up your street. In fact, he might be a little bit too honest. Now, he's 28, he's on a dating profile at the moment, and he said on his dating profile that the only thing that he's looking for is nothing too serious. He just wants sex, like straight sex.
So okay. Why are you using me as an example?
I'm just saying, like, because you're the only, you know, lady in the house who might be in.
You might want it, Mel.
I'm just saying. But now, there is a time limit on the sex. Not you, Charles, if there's anyone out there looking for a young
What's
man.
What's the time limit?
Who's single. He needs to be quite fast because he's going to prison very soon.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So, what's the turnaround time?
I mean, it could be the next 2 weeks. So if you're looking for anyone, he's on a dating app right now. 28.
One. Ricky. Melvin. Charlie. On BBC Radio 1.
Ooh, ooh, ayy. Hey. I got two white skinny chocolate. Throw the guy. One.
Coming up tomorrow.
On Weekend Breakfast with Matt and Molly.
You are on a mission to start every sentence with the next letter of the alphabet.
Are you up for it?
Am I?
Alphabetical.
With Joe Sugg and Casper Lee.
Listen tomorrow from 8.
Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1, from the album Ragamuffin Soundtape. That is Sinead Harnett featuring Shy FX, or Shy FX featuring Sinead Harnett, I should say. Too Shy, love that song. And he's got some really good collabos on there as well, man. He's got Maverick Sabre as well, Lily Allen, Getson, Kojoey, Radical, and Cara Delevingne as well. Okay, we're into hour two of our show. Welcome to Thursday Show, people.
So far tonight, we found out how Ricky was conceived. Hashtag rub off the wallpaper.
Yes! Okay. People are actually doing that, aren't they?
They're just hashtagging
people
it for fun.
People are texting in and hashtagging rub off the wallpaper.
For no reason other than to bring it up more and more. Keep those coming in, guys. Also coming up, we've got stupid question time. We've got a great question for you guys to answer today. We're going to need your help in a little bit. The number for that later on is 03700 100 100. It's BBC Radio 1.
Ricky Melvin.
Charlie, Radio 1. That's hot.
Massive shout to Marie, who just called the studio. Happy birthday to you, Marie. JK Heartache in the background on BBC Radio 1.
evening. My name is Ricky Hayward-Williams, and this is Stupid Question Time on BBC Radio 1. Joining me tonight are the right horrible Melvin O'Doom and the Esmeralda of Essex, the Dame of Dagenham, Charlotte Hedges. So... Okay, so to our first question, it comes from Omar from Liverpool. Omar?
Hi, guys, how's it going?
Hello.
All good, Omar.
All right, so my question for today. If you have three slices of bread stacked one on top of the other, is it a bread sandwich or is it just a pile of bread?
Okay, so we have that question from Omar.
What a question.
And Melvin and Charlie.
That's a great question. I've never really thought about it before. I think it needs some more digestion over this.
I like the way that you've used the word digestion, Mel. Very, very clever.
Not just a pretty face, Charles.
I wouldn't say that either.
Okay, so if, like Melvin and Charlie, you would also like to give your thoughts on Omar's question, call us now on 03700 100 100. Text us on 81199. My name is Ricky Hayward-Williams, and this is Stupid Question Time on BBC Radio 1.
Dr. Vades.
Bad bees. Any football match, man's winning it. Gang, ST Live or ringing it.
Dr. Vades, Chip, LD, and Lowski there, that's ringtone. It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
Okay, so we're still taking your calls and texts for Stupid Question Time. Hold tight for that coming up shortly, but I've got some new music for you guys right now. So, R&B artist Kehlani released her third studio album titled While We Wait in February this year, which I was so excited about because for me, her harmonies are always on point and I just love the tone of her voice. Now, she gave us albums You Should Be Here in 2015 and Sweet Sexy Savage in 2017. Both really good albums, but I feel the planets aligned for her on this one and everything just clicked into place. This is her new track. It's Kehlani with Feels on BBC Radio 1.
Kehlani Feels, it's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1. Good evening to ya!
Good evening and welcome back to Stupid Question Time on BBC Radio 1. tonight we are debating Omar in Liverpool's serious question, which was...
If I have three slices of bread stacked one on top of the other, is it just a stack of bread or is it a bread sandwich?
Interesting. Okay, so let's open the debate to the wider audience. Caller, what is your name and where do you come from?
Hi, I'm Chris from Warwickshire.
Hey,
Hello there, Chris. So what are your thoughts on today's question? If you've got three slices of bread on top of one another, is it a bread sandwich or just a pile of bread?
Just that simple. Depends if it's buttered.
Depends. So if it's got butter on it, what are you classing that as a sandwich, basically?
Yeah, definitely.
What if it's lettuce with no butter?
Lettuce with no butter. That's a stack of lettuce.
So you got the bread, then you got lettuce, then you got bread again, then lettuce, then bread. What is it?
Oh yeah, that's a sandwich. It's a vegetarian club sandwich.
You can't argue with that.
You're just saying.
You can't argue with that, Mel.
So just to be clear, Chris. So you're just saying, as long as there's something in between bread, that makes it a sandwich.
Yes.
But what if it's bread in between bread?
Just a bread stack.
Okay. I've got an issue with this because if you go into a supermarket and ask for a sandwich, you're never ever going to get bread with butter. That's a slice of toast.
What? Yeah, no, if you go into a supermarket and you ask for a sandwich, they're going to give you bread enough and then bread. No?
Well, what are your thoughts?
It doesn't matter what it is. It's something bread, something and bread.
Okay. No, that's fair enough, Chris.
Like a crisp sandwich.
Oh, I do love a crisp sandwich. What flavour do you go, though? What flavour, Chris?
Either cheese and onion or red and salted.
See, I'd say that was a stack of crisps, though.
Okay, I'm going to have to wrap this up. So, Melvin and Charlie, what are your final thoughts on this question?
I think as long as there's lubrication in between, then it becomes a sandwich.
You've got to have some lubrication in between.
Remember that, kids.
Okay, Chris.
Wow.
That is my key to life. As long as there's lubrication, you're good to go.
Lube it up, whatever it is.
Brilliant. Says, okay. Nice one, Chris.
Thank you so much, Chris, from Warwickshire. What okay, many thanks for listening to Stupid Question Time. If you have any questions, send them to rmc@bbc.co.uk. Thank you to the master of mellow, Mr. Melvin O'Doom, and the Cinderella of Southend, Charlotte Hedges. We'll be back on Stupid Question Time at the same time next week, live from London. I've been Ricky Hayward Williams, and this has been Stupid Question Time on BBC Radio 1.
So stupid!
Still loving this tune, Octavian, Skepta, Michael Phantom, Bet. It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie, BBC Radio 1.
So many shouts coming in, 81199. Three slices of bread. Is it a stack of bread or a bread sandwich? That is Stupid Question Time. Loads of shouts. As I said, my favourite one by far is Dan in Southampton. He said, it's a bread sandwich, you mug.
He's so upset. Just keep it simple.
Also shout out to Lucy from Bolton. Is the bread buttered? If it's buttered, it's a bread butty. Didn't think about that, actually.
These guys are coming with levels of
they're
sandwich.
Done well.
They're connoisseurs.
I just think as long as something, you've got two bits. I don't know why we're going back into it.
Who cares?
Leave it, Ricky.
It's Radio 1.
Ricky, Melvin, Charlie,
BBC Radio 1.
Karamani, Lose My Love on BBC Radio 1, 81199. Massive shout out to Chris from Bristol. Happy birthday, mate. Nice one for getting in touch. And shout out to Kyan as well.
All right, so we need to big up Greg James for having us on his breakfast show this week for a game called Yesterday's Quiz. So it's general knowledge questions, right, based on the day before. So on Monday, he had Radio 1 listener Georgia. She scored 13
She's
points.
She's amazing.
Then Charlie, you were really good. You scored 10 points on Tuesday's show. I was on Wednesday. I scored 9 points. So Ricky, you were on this morning.
I was.
We don't know what your score was.
No, I forgot to ask you today.
Now, how did you feel beforehand? Were you confident?
I was right, yeah.
Should we find out how you did?
Yeah.
All right, let's have a listen.
It's tough out there. Charlie with 10 on Tuesday, Melvin 9 yesterday. You finished the week, Ricky. I'm excited to hear the show tonight from 9 o'clock to hear the responses from your co-hosts. You got 8 today.
Oh, no!
Yeah.
My gosh! Oh, the shame. The shame.
No, as if you did. Your memory, I'm surprised at that because your memory is much better than ours.
Yeah, it is, but, you know, what can I say?
But I heard you had... No, I would say that your thing is sport. Yeah. You had 3 sport-related questions, right?
I don't know, I can't remember, but yeah.
You did.
Okay.
You did.
I got them all right.
You got them all right.
Yeah.
But you should have done better.
Shame on you.
The shame indeed. Night strikes,
where is my... You don't need a TV license if you're a student, right? Spoiler alert. If you watch or download BBC programmes on iPlayer or watch any live TV on any device, you need to be covered by a TV licence. Know the facts. Check if you need one. Visit tvl.co.uk/uni.
Sounds of Kendrick Lamar, BBC Radio 1, Ricky Melvin and Charlie. We are here until 11.
So I am really excited to be going in the mix on a Thursday, getting us all ready for the weekend, playing around with some of the tunes you might hear on our show and giving them a house twist, as well as throwing in some new big tunes as well. Get your shouts in, guys, 81199. We want to hear from you if you're listening, chilling at home, driving about, on the way out, whatever you are up to, get in touch and say hey, 81199. Should we kick things off, lads?
Yeah.
This is Club Charlie on BBC Radio 1.
This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping up.
Here we go. we go. Thursday night club, Charlie on BBC Radio 1. It's all about Medusa, Peace of Your Heart. Loving this one.
Shout out to everyone getting involved on the text, 81199. Shout out to the 4195. Charlie's absolutely slaying these tunes. Big up Alan from Port Talbot. Shout out to the 5414 Club Charlie. Best tunes on the radio. Got the cruise set, the volume set higher. Graham in long drive. He's driving home, he says. He's on a long drive home. He's feeling it, Charles. He's feeling
nice
it.
Nice one. Thanks, nice guys.
Keep him coming in. 81199.
BBC Radio 1, Hot Like Detroit, that thing. You loving this one, boys?
Yeah, man. You got loads of messages here online on text 81199. Shout to Anif, shout out to Shaz as well, and Mike. They're saying you're absolutely smashing it, Charlie!
Charlie Hedges in the mix on BBC Radio 1. It's Ricky, Melvin and Charlie. How's it going, guys?
All good, Charles.
All right, shout out to everyone getting involved in the texters again. Shout out to the 8275. Come on, Charlie, bang them cheese. Charlie's the new Mr. Jam.
Don't say that. It'll get me, Mr. Jam.
We love Mr. Jam. We love Mr.
Jam. I love him.
Shout out to the 2555. Loving them banging tunes. We're driving on the M4 on the way back from a great gig. Keep them coming in. 81199.
Club Charlie, I'll be in the mix every single Thursday for the last 30 minutes of the show. A massive shout out to Jack Saunders, who's up next. He's loving this one. Look at him go to the next studio.
Their studio's having an absolute blast right now.
I love this Panic at the Disco. Boys, we made it. Our first week on BBC Radio 1.
Yes, Charlie.
Can you believe it?
It's been absolutely fun, right?
Yeah, it's been so much fun. And we will catch you guys on Monday at 9 p.m.